The following is an exclusive presentation of KTVB Boise, your source for the best in sports.
NCAA college football is on the air. The Boise State Broncos in Pocatello to face the Idaho State Bengals. Last year, Tony Hilde leading his first victory as a college quarterback, the freshman from Pendleton, Oregon, taking the Broncos past Idaho State in Boise. 2 years ago, the Bengals' infamous Globe of Death kickoff return leading to a last-minute victory that cast a shadow over the rest of the Broncos' season. The Broncos and Bengals mix it up again next on Channel 7. Welcome to Holt Arena on the Idaho State University campus in Pocatello for Big Sky Football. The unbeaten Boise State Broncos, ranked 11th nationally in 1AA, facing in-state rival Idaho State, which is trying to even its record at 3-3. Bengals playing only their second home game of the season. Hello again, everyone. I'm Larry Manili to call tonight's game for you, along with Tom Scott. The Broncos warming up behind us for what likely will be their last football game ever in Holt Arena. Now stop that. It's impolite to cheer during the opening remarks. It's safe to say this is not a place that has been kind to Boise State teams over the years. The fans are not very friendly, and they've had a difficult time winning on the football field as well.
But the Broncos have eked out a lot of victories here. They won in 1990 handily, won in 1988 handily. They just happened to lose in the Globe of Death game 2 years ago. But it's going to be a big one tonight because the Bengals see this as their season.
And it is, by Brian McNeely's admission, the biggest game in the third year of his coaching stint as the head man with the Bengals. It will be important for the Bronco defense to keep the Bengals' explosive offense under control, and the main man, Joe O'Brien.
Joe O'Brien with 4 sacks in the past 2 games. They'll be moving him around a lot on the defensive line tonight, not only to stop Alfredo Anderson, but to put pressure on quarterback Rob Weta.
The two teams will be going after each other. There's a look at Joe O'Brien, and the Bronco defense has given up a lot of yards, but they've had that bend but don't break philosophy, stretching like a rubber band. And here's a guy who can stretch you to the max, Alfredo Anderson, the Big Sky Offensive Player of the Week for his efforts 7 days ago up in Bozeman.
Last week, a school record 271 yards at Montana State. However, the week before at Idaho, only 13 yards. So the Broncos would like to have him at least somewhere in between that. He is a great threat, the sophomore out of Miami. He's great in the open field. The Broncos want to keep him inside, keep him from hitting the perimeter.
He is a terrific athlete as well. He was the quarterback in spring ball and projected to be the guy who was going to quarterback this football team this fall, but he is at the tailback spot now, which is not to say he won't be throwing some passes, another element of their attack to keep in mind.
You never know anything you're going to see tonight from Brian McNeely.
Well, we are just minutes from kickoff. Stay with us. We'll have the starting lineups as we await the opening of this football game here in Pocatello.
Tonight's game between the Boise State Broncos and the Idaho State Bengals, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Flying the low-fare airline is just plain smart. U.S. Bank of Idaho. We're here for the real risk-takers in Idaho, small business owners. Blacker's Complete Home Furnishings, America's name brand headquarters, where you always buy for less. Chili's Grill and Bar. Chili's, it's like no place else. And your Treasure Valley Dodge dealers. See all that's new from the new Dodge at your Treasure Valley Dodge dealer.
freedom, the symbol of American liberty, the right to make our own decisions. One politician believes the government should prohibit a woman's right to choose, Helen Chenoweth. Larry LaRocco believes a woman and her family should have the right to choose, not the politicians. That's why Larry LaRocco has never backed down in defending the freedom of choice. And that's the difference. Larry LaRocco for Congress. Idaho values working for us.
What if you took the best-selling car in America, Ford Taurus, and gave it something special, like sport bucket seats, a rear spoiler, and aluminum wheels, and then you added a whole list of other standard features like dual airbags, air conditioning, and power windows and locks? Well, you'd probably have a car that just went out of your price range, right? Wrong. Introducing the new 95 Taurus SE, a special edition. Now with the same 2.9% financing or 500 cash back you can get on every Taurus model. For limited time, only at your local Ford dealer.
Welcome back to Holt Arena in Pocatello, where we await the start of tonight's Big Sky game between the Broncos and the Bengals, who warmed up in orange and have gone to basic black for tonight's game.
Could be Notre Dame 1977 when the Irish changed jerseys in the locker room before that game against USC, or 1984 when Boise State did the same thing in the game against Idaho and didn't fare as well as the Irish did in 1977. So see how it transpires tonight, but the Broncos have won the toss and elected to receive.
Look at the series between the two teams. The Broncos have dominated since they began competition in 1968, winning last year. It was their only Big Sky victory of the season. And the place not filling as rapidly as we had expected it might. The ISU officials had predicted a close to capacity crowd of 12,000. There are a good 1,000 Bronco fans here, we're guessing, down to our lower right. At least 500-600 tickets sold in Boise during the week, and a lot of folks just drove over and bought tickets at the door coming in. The last victory, you remember, 2 years ago, the infamous Globe of Death kickoff return that set up the game-winning touchdown for ISU in the final minute of play. Broncos with a lot at stake tonight, an unbeaten season, the best start in school history. They are ranked 11th in the nation. And depending on how the rest of the ranked teams have fared, a chance perhaps to move into the top 10.
Deep
Willie Bowens.
And also back there is Del Graven, seeing his first action of 1994. Del Graven, one of the up men.
He'll be at the far side of the screen, a little pooch kick. Fumble, and the Bengals are going to have it, it appears. We'll wait till they unpile, because it flew right into a black jersey. And we'll see who comes out of there with it.
This one may start just like the NAU game, and the Broncos can only hope that it finishes the same way. Broncos are signaling that they got it. Amazingly enough, Chadwick Bird, among all those black shirts, fell on the ball, and the Broncos will have it at their own 25-yard line.
Now, that's about as horrible a start as Pokey Allen could ever have envisioned.
I don't know if it was an intentional pooch kick, but they do want to keep it out of the hands of Willie Bowens, who had a 70-yarder last week. Willie, it almost bounces into Willie's arms, but then out of Willie's arms after the initial fumble, and Chadwick Bird somehow
got to the bottom of the pile. And after all that, referee Dick Brodigan advises the crowd, we'll do it again.
Pepsi Cola is proud of the official soft drink of Holt Arena.
It was Corey Johnson who initially fumbled.
Here's a look at the officiating crew. Dick Brodigan from Spokane, assisted by Art Hines of Arizona, Bob Blair of Ogden, Mike Feldman of Arizona, Gary LaFour is from up in Moscow, Bob Rowling is from Butte, and Scott Marshan from here in Pocatello is our Red Cap TV coordinator.
So that moves it back. James Farrell doing the kicking off for Idaho State, one of the nation's most highly regarded high school kickers last year. He is a true freshman.
And here we go again. Willie Bowens cheating up a little. This a skipper through the hands of Del Graven. Willie Bowens fields it at the 20 to the 25, and now out to the 27-yard line. Bowens had a chance perhaps to bring it this way, but he decided to go north-south and settle for a yard or two.
Del Graven still clearly getting a feel for football. He has just practiced 3 times since walking on the Bronco football team on Monday. the junior from Vail, Oregon. So Tony Hilde will bring him up on the 28-yard line of Boise State.
Hilde, of course, comes in with impressive numbers, 14 touchdowns, only four interceptions, 54% completion on the season. Broncos starting from their 27-yard line, first and 10. Split receivers and split backs behind Hilde. The fake draw. And Hilde coming this way to the 30, where he's hit hard and fights his way to the 35-yard line. Gain of 7, almost 8.
Great effort by Tony Hilde. He had great protection that time, could not find anybody open, so he took off.
Look at the backs and receivers for the Broncos. Corey Johnson stepping in at fullback this week. Hauski Akibi and the tight end Matyshock joining Casey Adams. Jeffrey Venus, Kaufman, Toyos, and LePain across the front. And they got good news with Steve Brushy back in uniform this week. Going to see his first action tonight. That's Bernie Zimmerman in motion. Little play action. Hilde on the roll. Had a notion. He had Hauski at midfield, but chose to tuck it and take the one-yard gain, and it'll be third and a short two.
Tried to duck under Derek Carter to get the first down, but he'll be short.
Here's a look at the Bengal defense across the front. Hayes has 8 quarterback sacks. Violetti, Ta'ualupe, Scott Getz, Carter, and Johnson are the backers, and the secondary of Barnes, a true freshman, Brown and Tolles. Third and a short two for Boise State. Opening minute and a half. Casey Adams bounces it outside and into the secondary by the first tackler and across the 40-yard line before he's driven out of bounds. That is Casey Adams at his best.
The battle of the A-back starts with Casey Adams. His first carry of the night goes all the way to the Bengal 38-yard line. The trap play that the Broncos have had such success with. Casey running behind right tackle Jordy LePain, getting a great block there from Hauski and from Bernie Zimmerman, and then juking his way down to the Bengal 38-yard line.
Gain of 26 yards for Casey Adams in his first carry. Adams again stumbled over a blocker and gains about 3 to the 35-yard line.
Broncos at a one-back set that time, 3 wide receivers going with the draw to Casey.
Talked with Al Borges this afternoon, the offensive coordinator of the Broncos. They anticipate a lot of blitzing. They expect the Bengals to come hard and with a lot of people after Tony Hilde, and they hope to use some play action and try to slow that down with Casey Adams' quickness in the line.
Also quite a few screens in the game plan tonight.
Hilde with the play fake. Going downfield, Bernie Zimmerman, touchdown Broncos!
Zimmerman's first touchdown. As a college football player, the Broncos made it look easy. Zimmerman going on the streak, beating the linebacker, and getting the Broncos on the board with a 73-yard drive.
Just 2.5 minutes into the game, Greg Erickson to attempt the conversion out of Tony Hilde's hold. Joe O'Brien, the long snapper. Penalty flag before the ball is moved. Bernie Zimmerman, a 6'4", 236-pound junior from Moscow, transfer from the University of Idaho.
False start.
He is one happy fellow. Boy, that was an early false start on the offensive line there on the point after attempt. So Erickson will have to kick it from the 15. A 25-yard field goal in effect, but right down the middle of the field.
A high snap, the kick is blocked. And so the Broncos will miss the conversion. And with 12:34 remaining here in the first quarter, Boise State has grabbed a 6-0 lead.
The Bengals looking at this game to turn the season around and turn the coaching career around for Brian McNeely, who's been under a little bit of heat down here in Pocatello. As we take a look at the touchdown. Play action there by Hildy, and you see Zimmerman, a blown coverage by a linebacker, and Bernie lopes into the end zone with the Broncos' first points of the night. But since 1988, Idaho State 16-53-1. So trying to turn the football fortunes around as you get a look at Ossie Violetti on the Idaho State sideline. The Bengals wearing these black uniforms. They warmed up in their orange jerseys and white pants, but they are all in black tonight for Boise State in the Broncos' last trip to Holt Arena.
Greg Erickson now to kick it off for Boise State. The deep man will be Alfredo Anderson, number 8, and Kennedy Nkiasson. Am I saying that right?
I believe you are. He's a Canadian by way of Ghana. He's a native of Ghana who comes from Saskatchewan.
He has 7 returns for 100 yards, an average of 14. Anderson has 12 for an average of 22. It is Nkiasson across the 20 and then brought down.
See what kind of changes the Broncos have made on defense.
The Bengals will start with Rob Weta at quarterback. He is out of Colorado Springs. True freshman, 6'4", 180-pounder. Comes in with pretty good numbers, 56% completion, better than 1,000 yards through the air, 6 touchdowns and 4 interceptions. So not the 2-to-1 or better ratio that you'd like, but he's got a dangerous weapon behind him in Alfredo Anderson. Play fake to Anderson. Weta wants to go deep. Got a man. Completed. Josh Gibbs across the 35. First down out at the 39-yard line.
Broncos playing a little bit soft that time. Gibbs ran a curl pattern. Came up underneath after the play action by Rob Weta.
Anderson with Kay, Waters, Wheeler, and Gibbs. And when they go to a wide receiver set, the fullback Kay is replaced by either Clifford Young or Carter. And up front, the Bengals across the line with Pale, Verbus, Clark, Lawson, and Birch. First and 10 ISU at the Bengal 39. Anderson bouncing it outside. Vince Watson got him. He scrambled away, but gets back just to the original line of scrimmage, maybe half yard.
Exactly what the Broncos want to do. Get good pursuit on Alfredo Anderson whenever he hits the perimeter. Nothing going inside, which is where the play was designed. Vince Watson, getting his first start, made a great stop.
Across the front, Shepard, Fifita, Thompson, and O'Brien beginning to come in their own. Watson starting outside with Smith, and on the other side, Reed, and then the secondary with Gale, Walk Green, Cook, and Payne. Second and a long 9.
And the no huddle continues for the Bengals.
Play fake to Anderson. Weta under pressure has Gibbs again. Tackle made by Chris Cook at the 44-yard line.
Threw it a little bit high. Short gain. Chris Shepard and Stephon Reed making the stop. And the Idaho State fans don't like the spot. He did not get good forward progress on that.
And I've got to say, they've got a good point. I thought that ball was nearly to the 45-yard line when Cook drove him back. Gibbs out of Grace High School. Big, strong senior. Third and 7. Weta to throw. Under a pressure and tripped up, and down he goes.
Chris Wing. Chris Wing is the key man on long situations tonight with Jerris King not suited up. Chris Wing came like a shot. He did not even practice Wednesday because he is banged up a little bit, but boy, showed no effects of it there as he comes from the left side and trips up Rob Weta for a big loss.
Bengals will have to kick it away. James Farrell, a freshman out of Bishop, California, averaging just under 36 yards. His longest of the season is 43. Casey Adams waiting at the Bronco 30. He will fair catch it at the 31. And that's where the Broncos will have it when we return with 9:58 in the first quarter. Boise State up 6-0 on ISU.
Dakota Sport V6 has more. More horsepower. More shoulder room. More hip room.
and more cargo room than a comparable Ford Ranger or Chevy S10. But you don't have to put everything you've got into it. Dakota Sport V6. A little bigger, a lot better.
See all that's new at your friendly Northwest Dodge dealer.
It's time for friends to fly free on Southwest Airlines.
Wake up and smell the coffee.
And people are friendlier than ever. Just make reservations at least a day in advance and buy your round-trip ticket at Southwest's regular low unrestricted fare, and a friend flies with you, free, anywhere we fly.
Yo, Dad, what do you think?
Friends fly free on Southwest, the low-fare airline. Call 1-800-IFLY-SWA.
Broncos back on offense for their second possession of the night, having driven the ball 73 yards to a touchdown just 2.5 minutes ago, holding Idaho State to first down and then three downs and a punt. Broncos beginning their second possession from the 31-yard line, leading 6-0. We played just over 5 minutes. Hildy rolling away and going deep down the middle for Ryan Akibi, who, had the ball at the 15-yard line and couldn't hang on.
He was disrupted there a little bit by cornerback Marcus Jackson, and we have an injured Bengal, Chris Tolles, at the end of that play, but Marcus Jackson, I think, just distracted, got a hand in the way of Akibi as the ball went through his arms. A great throw by Tony Hilde.
Boy, he put that ball out there. He has got a strong arm. Chris Tolles, a 5'10 junior, 185-pounder out of Oxford, Mississippi, a transfer from Northwest Mississippi Junior College, shaken up, and that's a longtime Bengal trainer Phil Lucky, who is working on him.
So Tolles, a cornerback. The Bengals have brought in Brian Bethel, a free safety, to replace him at corner. Either that or they will make a move with a safety to cornerback.
We'll take a break. 9:49 left, first quarter. Broncos up 6-0 on the Idaho State Bengals here in Pocatello.
Blacker's 45th anniversary sale is on now, and prices have been drastically reduced on entire stocks of inventory. Anniversary discounts from Sony, RCA, GE, Maytag, Whirlpool, Amana, Lazy Boy, Broyhill, Sealy, and more. Plus, get two free airline tickets to Orlando, the Bahamas, Cancun, Mexico, or Hawaii with any purchase of $599 or more. 6 months same as cash, savings up to 70% during the 45th anniversary sale on now at Blacker's, where you always buy for less.
My wife says I look great since I've been working out twice a week.
I've been working out every day.
Luckily, I just discovered Chili's Guiltless Grill.
Really? I knew about it months ago.
Good. Every dish is really low in fat. My Guiltless Veggie Pasta with fresh tomato sauce has only 11 grams of fat.
Oh, yeah? Well, my Guiltless Chicken Salad with Southwest Dressing has only 3 grams of fat.
I walked here.
I jogged.
I was going uphill.
I was going against the wind.
I was carrying weights.
I was wearing really heavy sweats.
Larry Manili and Tom Scott with you live again from Pocatello. The Broncos ready to begin their second possession. Second and 10 now. Chris Tolles was helped off the field with what appears to be some sort of knee injury. His knee pad was rolled up, replaced, as Tom said, by Brian Bethel. Hildy going to the air again. No, pulls it down across the 30 to the 33-yard line, and it'll be third and about 7, maybe 8 yards for a first down.
Hildy, as usual, taking some shots. You got to look at Chris Tolles on the sideline, J.C. transfer from Northwest Mississippi, J.C., bump and run specialist who appears to be out of the ball game. He's been a real important part of the Bengal defense so far this season. Broncos faced with a third and long. Tony maybe pulled it in a little bit quickly that time. He had some time.
Third and 8, the Broncos were a better than their average last week. They converted almost 50% in their win over Weber, and that was a big factor. This is Hildy with pressure. It's a fumble, and Idaho State's got it. Hildy wanted an incompletion, but he'll walk off disappointed. The Bengals have the turnover at the 27-yard line.
It's Josh Hayes from Homedale High School, played for Bronco great Jim McMillan there.
That's the second fumble this year that Hayes has forced. Well, and let's give credit to the guy coming from the other side as well.
The ball was sitting right there. The Broncos thought it was a forward motion with the arm, but it was not, and the Bengals have a great opportunity to get it right back at the Broncos, who lead 6-0.
There's a
Josh Hayes from Homedale.
Good look at Josh Hayes, and it looked like Alapate Taualupe from the other side who actually got the first hit on Hildy. Well, you can see the turnovers favor the Broncos coming in, but they give up the first one here. Alfredo Anderson slips the first tackler and drags another. Pete Walk Green finally pulls him down at the 21 after a gain of about six.
Broncos forced him back inside. They don't want him to hit the outside. Saw what he did last weekend at Montana State. There's Alfredo's season, 271 of that 441 last week at MSU. He's averaging 80 yards a game. Four touchdowns, seven touchdowns overall for Anderson.
Averaging 5.5 yards per carry and a long one of 65. He has got explosive speed. Shotgun formation now, and Weta burns a timeout. 8:16 remaining. We'll take one as well. Bengals with an opportunity when we come back.
Listen up, all you hunters, hikers, and woodsmen. You won't find a better selection of what you need this fall than at Koppel's Brownsville. Safety vests, camouflage wear, knives, boots, binoculars, all this and more. We're your outdoor supply store. Come see what we mean.
Your family outfitters. So much to get at Koppel's Brownsville.
Come on, Daddy.
Come on.
Daddy.
If you're going to spend extra time on something,
Daddy.
Spend it with your best friend, not a loan application. Call 1-800-US-LOANS.
Idaho State Bengals with a chance to get back in this football game, trailing 6-0, forcing the fumble by Bronco quarterback Tony Hildy. The Bengals with a first down at the BSU 27-yard line. Alfredo Anderson picking up six with a first play from scrimmage. Rob Weta conferring with head coach Brian McNeely on the near sideline. And he returns. The Bengals already at the line of scrimmage as they go with a no-huddle offense here in the first quarter. 8:16 remaining.
They will sometimes go with a no-cadence offense. Silent counts.
That's Anderson in motion over the middle. Pass completed.
Sam Carter, or Romy Wheeler, his 28th catch of the season. Wheeler's the one who caught the winning touchdown 2 years ago. From the shotgun, Weta with a lot of time, just an easy throw over the middle as Wheeler came underneath Brian Smith. Smith catches up to him, and then Walk Green bends him back. Looks like the Bengals will have enough for the first down, although they will measure here. I think another, maybe not a spot in favor of Idaho State, because it looked like he got down to about the 21-yard line. First down, ISU.
So a fresh series of downs from the 17.
And Broncos have practiced defensively against the no huddle all week.
Broncos with the five defensive backs, four wide receivers in there. Anderson trying to pop it inside and carrying tacklers to the 12-yard line, a gain of five.
Good effort by Anderson. Travis Thompson hanging on to him and Stephon Reed finishing him off as they went up the middle that time. Another look at the newcomer of the year last year in the Big Sky Conference, also first team all Big Sky, gained 160 yards against BSU and Broncos Stadium last year.
Weta to throw. Got Wheeler, and he'll score.
Ball popped out after he crossed the plane of the goal line, and ISU has tied it up after a Bronco turnover. 17 yards from Rob Weta to Romy Wheeler, his fourth touchdown of the season. Weta's fifth touchdown pass of the season. The Broncos made their first drive look easy, 73 yards, but turnovers might end up being a big story in this ballgame. It is at the moment, as James Farrell will try the extra point as opposed to Eric Linoci.
They've used both, and the kick is good, and the Bengals have taken the lead with 7:25. The Broncos' missed conversion is the difference in this football game right now.
This is only the second home game of the season for Idaho State, and their first since September 3rd when they beat Adams State, Division II school, 54-0. The Bengals play five of their last six here in Holt Arena.
Take another look at that last play as Rob Weta.
Broncos couldn't get pressure on Weta in time as Romy Wheeler once again came underneath, broke one tackle and got a block from another wide receiver.
And Keith Walk Green simply arriving too late to do any damage to Romy Wheeler's effort to get the ball in the end zone. And the Bengals are up 7-6 with 7:25 left here in the first quarter. And that will get the crowd into the game. It is not going to be close to capacity. A couple of end zone sections to our left are less than half full. But it's a crowd of 8,000 or 9,000, I'll guess. Maybe more, maybe close to 10.
I would say so. Bronco coaches hope that touchdown gets the Broncos into the game. Coaching staff admitted that the team was not ready to play last week, and they almost paid for it against Weber State. They had a great week of practice.
Felt that they were going to have an excellent effort tonight. Said that they had had, in fact, their best week of practice on a consistent basis. Every day was a solid effort. Farrell with the line drive kick off the hands and through the end zone.
Corey Johnson fortunate that the ball had the momentum to go into the end zone. That could have been another dangerous play. As it is, the Broncos take over at their own 20, trailing 7-6. 27-yard scoring drive in just four plays after the Hildy fumble. 13 yards, I believe it was 13 yards from Rob Weta to Romy Wheeler as Idaho State in the lead, 7-6. Lee Schrack into the game now for the Broncos at wide receiver.
Hildy now operating his team, first and 10 from the 20. It's Bernie Zimmerman, the motion man. Hand off to Casey Adams. Good ankle tackle on the outside there.
That was Marcus Jackson. Casey tried to do his patented in-the-face jukes and was not able to pull it off. And now we have a Bengal shaken up on the play. It's Rick Brown who missed the Montana State game last week with an ankle injury. Big number 90, senior from Santa Fe Springs, California. He missed last week's game, and now that ankle appears to be bothering him again as he comes off the field.
Brown, number 90, is a co-captain of this team. Transfer from Fullerton Community College in Southern California. Broncos now with second and 8 from their 22-yard line. Hildy with Adams and Johnson behind him. Play fake to Johnson, finds Adams, who beats the first tackler, and then Moore, and now has some room on the far side. 30, 35, pulls over a tackler to the 38-yard line. He ran over
Marcus Jackson.
Ran him over.
The same guy he was unable to juke before. A great play fake that time by Hildy. Allowed Adams to get into the flat in the first of the screens that we will see tonight from the Broncos. There's the play fake inside to Corey Johnson. And the screen set up to Adams, and Adams does a lot of this himself. Juke number one, juke number two, and then he reverses his field, meets Marcus Jackson, and gets 5 extra yards.
Broncos now with a first down at the 39-yard line. Penalty flag.
Looks like it'll be procedure against Boise State as the play is blown dead.
Now I see the play clock has reset at 25, so it might have expired. but the Broncos moving backward.
Illegal procedure will move the ball back to the...
There's a good look at Brian McNeely, the third-year head coach of the Idaho State Bengals, an overall record of 7-20, and boy, did he need and appreciate the road win last weekend in Bozeman.
That ended an 18-game losing streak to 1AA or 1A schools. Their last victory over a 1AA school was here in the Globe of Death game against BSU 2 years ago.
Broncos now with first and 15 from the 34. Adams inside and back to the original line of scrimmage. He got the five back, and it'll be second and 10.
Quick hitter inside to Casey, who now has four carries for 36 yards, including a 26-yarder on the first Bronco drive, which resulted in a touchdown to Bernie Zimmerman from Tony Hilde.
Zimmerman into the game now, replacing Ryan Akibi. So look for the Broncos to feature double tight ends, although Zimmerman at this point sets up in the backfield.
He'll go in motion.
Second and 10, Hilde play fake. Overthrew Johnson. Johnson makes the catch and hangs on. He gains four, but he really paid for them.
That was Ike Johnson, outside linebacker, making the hit on Corey Johnson.
Yeah, Corey Johnson comes in, a guy who'd only caught three passes this year. That's great concentration.
Corey has dropped the ball a couple times this season, so that's a great job by Corey Johnson. Play fake to Casey Adams and the roll right by Hilde and boo.
Third and 7 for the Broncos from their own 41-yard line. Hilde got Casey Adams at the Bengal 40. He could go all the way. 20, 10, touchdown Broncos. No flags.
59 yards.
Well, when the first man misses Casey Adams in the open field, it's over. I said he could go all the way.
And there just happened to be nobody left that time.
And in truth, he pulled away from the closest man to him from the first step he took.
Casey running inside and then out, an out pattern out of the backfield. And you're not going to catch him that way. Hilde with his second touchdown pass of the night here in the first period, but the Broncos will go for two as they only lead it 12-7 right now.
Trying to make up for the missed conversion kick after their first touchdown.
Broncos 5 of 5 on two-point attempts.
Hilde with the roll, cuts in.
And he got the ball across the goal line.
Indication is good. So the Broncos get the two-point conversion, and they lead it 14-7, 4:35 remaining in the first quarter. Broncos will kick it off to ISU when we come back.
Mega jackpot alert. Mega jackpot alert.
Hey, it could happen.
Every morning at each and every taco time, we're starting fresh. Yeah, it's a lot of work. It takes time. We could do it the easy way, but we know you'd taste the difference. You want your food made fresh, naturally. Food this good doesn't happen overnight. It happens every morning. Now enjoy crisp meat or bean burritos, just 99 cents. Crisp chicken burritos, just $1.69.
We make it fresh every day. Taco time.
Broncos have regained the lead, 14-7. Greg Erickson ready to kick it off now. The co-return men, 16 is Kennedy and Kayson, and that's number 8, Alfredo Anderson. Anderson averaging 22 yards per return with a long of 39, and Kayson averaging 14 per return with a long of 24. The kick to Kayson and through his hands, through the end zone. The Bengals will start at the 20.
That's more like it for Greg Erickson, who did not have a good week kicking last week against Weber State. kicking game a little bit off last week. That's more like the Greg Erickson we have seen earlier in the season.
Bengals averaging 388 yards and 30 points offensively, nearly 31. But they have turned it over 16 times coming into the game. Turned it over more than their opposition. Now they'll start from the 20. Rob Wetta up under center with a toss to Anderson. It's fumbled. The ball is loose.
Looks like Idaho State got it back. Although the Broncos are now pointing in their direction and almost a signal for the Broncos.
Bronco ball. That's Joe O'Brien coming out of there pumping a fist, and the Broncos have it at the Willie Market. Inside the 15.
I believe it was Stephon Reed who was there early, and Alfredo Anderson saw it all the way. Here you see Stephon Reed right in his face. Anderson trying to run before he made the catch, the most fundamental thing
Chris
in football.
Cook down there, O'Brien down there, Chris Shepard in there. The Broncos have it inside the 15, and now a chance to open things up a little bit on the scoreboard if they can take advantage of this opportunity. 4:25 left, first quarter. Hilly with a full house backfield. Zimmerman, the motion man. Casey Adams with a blocker. 10 to the 9. Second and 4.
Casey just playing along the line of scrimmage there until he found his seam. Running behind Keith Jeffrey and Steve Brushy, who is now actually at left tackle now, is John Miller. And Steve Brushy at left guard for the Broncos. So Keith Jeffrey not in the game right now. Across the front, Paul Kaufman at center. Alex Toyos at right guard. Jordy LePain is the right tackle.
Tony Hilde adjusting. Broncos 18 of 19. That is efficiency. And this is Adams to the 2. First and goal. 15 touchdowns and 3 field goals. When they've had the ball inside the 20 of the opposition, they've scored 18 times out of 19.
Broncos tried it left behind Miller and Brushy, right behind Toyos and LePain and Kaufman, and have it on the 1 yard line. And I guess you dance with who brung you, and that's Casey Adams on this drive.
Keith Jeffrey back in there now at left tackle.
Jermaine Hudson now in the game for the Broncos at fullback.
And Brushy at the left guard. Casey Adams repelled at the 1. Second and goal.
They give him forward progress to the 3/4 yard line, but I think that's a matter of watching films, as Casey did the vault last week, 2 times successfully against Weber State, and then was caught with a brick wall in midair on his 3rd attempt, and same thing there for Casey Adams.
Broncos with second and goal.
Goal line offense.
Casey Adams, touchdown Broncos.
Casey just leans forward into the end zone to get his 8th touchdown of the season rushing, his 12th overall as he leads the Big Sky in scoring. So KC, all 17 of those yards, or rather 15 of those yards after the Alfredo Anderson fumble.
Erickson's conversion is good, and the Broncos now up 21-7, 2:43 left here in the first quarter in Pocatello.
Broncos wanted to get off to a quick start tonight. One thing that they talked about in practice was a quick start so that their defense could dictate the game. Against Idaho, Alfredo Anderson only gained 13 yards because the Vandals had an early lead. And last week when the Bengals got up, they were able to use Alfredo Anderson at will. So we'll see how that changes here as we look at the touchdown by Casey Adams. You see Steve Brushy there involved, and Randy Mattershot with a good block. It really not a lot of problem getting Casey into the end zone for the 18th time on the ground this season and 12th time overall.
James, Jermaine Hudson leading the way as the blocking fullback, and now Greg Erickson ready to kick it off again to Anderson and and Kiasen.
Casey Adams with a 51-yard first quarter unofficially so far. See if Greg Erickson can put this one into the end zone as well.
He rips it pretty good to the near corner, and Anderson will allow it to roll out of the end zone. The Bengals will start again from their 20-yard line, trailing Boise State 21-7.
Turnovers now even in this game at one, and touchdowns off turnovers even in this game at one. As you look at Pokey Allen and his good buddy Mike Young doing the core duty today, Mike's getting really good at that. You notice?
Bronco wrestling coach has become a good buddy of the head football coach. A reminder that later in the game, we'll be picking our Taco Time player of the game.
Performance this good only at Taco Time.
Certainly Casey Adams has made his statement, but Tony Hilde right there with him as well with a couple of touchdown passes in the early going.
His 15th and 16th of the year.
2:43 left first quarter. Anderson in the flat, and a good sure-handed tackle out there by Stephon Reed keeps it to a 5-yard gain.
Stephon Reed certainly didn't want to be juked, staying his ground as Anderson may have started his juke a little bit early. The great thing about Adams is he jukes in your face, and there's not a lot you can do about it. Weta getting the call from the sideline, and then he'll translate it. The Broncos, despite the no-huddle offense, have a chance to set things up defensively here because it does take time still to call the play. The play clock has not started yet.
Anderson again in the flat, and again it's Stephon Reed with the sure tackle.
Well, Anderson's role in this game has changed a little bit. They just want to get the ball to him on the outside and let him do his one-on-one thing. Broncos staying at home. Good time here for Weta. Out of the shotgun, loops it out to Anderson. DeJuan Miller misses the first tackle, but Stephon Reed, and who has gotten better every game since the middle of last season, makes the stop.
Got some help there from Travis Thompson, the junior out of Glendale Junior College in Southern California. There you see the remaining time in the first quarter on third and four. Completed pass out across the 45-yard line.
That's Justin Young, only his fifth catch of the year. He really took a hit there from Keith Watt Green. A lot of guys have really taken hits this season from Keith Watt Green, and Young is going to have to come out of the game and get his breath back.
Young, a redshirt freshman, 5'11", 160-pounder.
But it is a 20-yard gain after the 47-yard line, as you see Weta getting good time in the shotgun tonight. Good protection by the ISU offensive line, and there's the hit right in the gut by Keith Watt Green. But the Bengals on the move after a third and three.
A 20-yard completion, the longest of the season for Justin Young.
He's a freshman from Laie, Hawaii.
Rob Weta now, first down, Bengals from their own 47. Joe O'Brien chasing him. He gets the ball away, pass caught by Sam Carter, the senior out of Tallahassee, Florida, by way of Mississippi Delta Community College. Gain of 8.
Good pressure this time from the Bronco defensive line, but they didn't have the angle on the left side, and Carter was able to run a comeback route and get close to a first down 2 yards away.
It'll be second and 2 from the Bronco 45-yard line in the final minute of this first quarter. Anderson caught for a half-yard loss.
Chris Cook knifing in from his strong safety position and making the stop on Alfredo.
So it's third now and almost 3. Big down for the Bengals to stay in this football game. They need to keep this drive alive, and the Broncos trying to prevent that. In fact, you wonder if Idaho State might be in four down territory here at this point on the field. The surge, and it looks like first down yardage was at Craig Joseph.
Backup fullback.
Another freshman, a true freshman, 5'11", 210-pounder, and he picks up the first down inside the Bronco 42.
Dive play as the Broncos were watching Anderson. A good second effort by Joseph gets him down inside the BSU 42 to keep things going as we are at the end of the first quarter.
So while the teams visit at the sideline,
the horn's right next to us.
And trade ends, we'll take a break. End of one. Broncos up by two touchdowns on their in-state rivals from Pocatello.
Hi, I'm Dee Pickett. To compete on the pro rodeo circuit, I have to be in good condition. That's why I work out at the Canyon Athletic Club in Nampa.
And right now, the first 100 people to join Canyon Athletic Club this month will pay just $129 for one full year. Call Canyon Athletic Club at 467-9233 or stop by. We're located at the corner of Midland and Nampa Caldwell Boulevard, right behind Wendy's.
So whatever your reason for getting in shape, this is the place, Canyon Athletic Club in Nampa.
The arteries that nourish Idaho carry water. With fresh, clean water, we've got futures. Without water, our state begins to die. Phil Batt grew up on the land. He stood at the head gate waiting for his water. He says not one drop of our water for other states. His opponent for governor favors drawdowns, which require sending Idaho water downstream. Two candidates, two distinct points of view. Phil Batt, governor.
Ready to start the second quarter now. Idaho State with possession, and their main man, Alfredo Anderson, has been held in check for the most part by the Broncos. Anderson through the first quarter with 9 yards gained on five carries.
Casey Anderson, meanwhile, 51 yards. It's Weta who's doing a good job, though. He was 8 for 8 in the first period.
Play fake here, wants to go deep over the middle. Got his man, Romy Wheeler, 26-yard line. First down, Idaho State.
Romy Wheeler appealing to the crowd to get into the game as he ran a crossing route underneath. Play fake to Anderson, froze the Broncos momentarily, provided good time for Weta. And in front of Rasheed Gale, Wheeler makes the catch.
The second down has been the most productive for the Bengals. 43 of their points have come in the second period. More than any other during their first five games.
But up under center once again, doesn't like what he sees as the Broncos showed a six-man front.
A penalty flag in the Broncos secondary, but the Bengals charged with their timeout. It's their second. I thought they had called one earlier. We'll double check on that. We've played a half minute here in the second. Yeah, they had three showing on the scoreboard as well.
Nice in your life at Michael's Furniture Showplace.
Michael's Furniture Showplace must relocate this warehouse.
Our lease is up and we're building a new one.
$3 million of furniture must be sold to save moving costs.
Everything at Slash to save you money, plus...
No down payment, no payment, and no interest till April.
Come on in for the best selection. It's the $3 million warehouse liquidation sale.
This label tells you it's 100% cotton. This label tells you it's 100% real cheese. And this label tells you it's 100% low fares. Always check the label. Southwest, the low fare airline. Southwest Airlines wrote the book on low fares. And it's available in paperback. Low fares to more places more often. Fly Southwest, the low fare airline.
What's the old line from Bambi? Winter has come to the forest. It's come to southeast Idaho, and the dome has sprung a leak.
Well, it's 24 years old. They may need to re-shingle the thing.
I hope it doesn't get any wetter outside. And I'm not sure where on the field that would affect. At any rate, the Bengals have first and 10 from the Bronco 26, trying to climb back in it. Pass caught.
Great effort there once again by Justin Young to get another Bengal first down.
Inside the 16-yard line.
Weta looks right and goes left. A hook pattern run by Young, and Jason Payne trying to bring him down.
He's just hanging on at that point. A couple of lightweights out there.
Yep, Payne's a big hitter. He's only 150 pounds, though. And Young, only 160.
First down Bengals at the 15-yard line. Alfredo Anderson takes it upfield for a gain of one.
And who makes the stop again? Stephon Reed. The It's almost like Reed is assigned to number eight tonight. Ryan Smith, the other number eight for Boise State, also in on the stop for the Broncos. Broncos really want to keep him out of the end zone here because 14-point lead in this part of the game, obviously not very comfortable.
Bengals with second down and nine from the 14-yard line. For folks who will anticipate Sisters, we will, of course, be going through that 9 o'clock hour with this game, and the show will be seen tomorrow night after the incomplete at the 5. The fans want a flag, and they get a late flag.
Is that a late flag or what?
Very late from the near corner.
I don't know if we'll be able to see it here at the end of the play. Good time once again out of the shotgun for Rob Weta. Loops it over the top. Tough to see if Chris Cook got there early.
He certainly was playing the ball all the way. Now, whether he made contact with the intended receiver or not, I'm not sure.
Well, it will be a first down on the Idaho State 5-yard line.
Interference against Cook.
Troy Waters from Pocatello, the intended receiver.
Defensive pass interference on the offense, on the defense. That's a spot foul, first down.
So it'll be first and goal inside the 6-yard line.
Got it, Troy!
Bronco defense has been very tough inside the 20-yard line, but it's given up one touchdown already tonight after the Hildy fumble.
Anderson breaks it outside. And Stephon Reed got enough of his jersey to hang on while help arrived. Still a gain of two. Just to reiterate what I said about Sisters, for those who didn't fully understand or missed that, at 11:30 tomorrow night, following Bronco Spotlight with Pokey Allen, Tom and I will be joined by the Bronco coach. Sisters will air in its entirety at that time.
Great job by Travis Thompson and Joe O'Brien of bottling that play up at the beginning.
And next play, we joined in progress, and no gain there. Well, perhaps a half yard.
Stephon Reed once again, along with Travis Thompson, making the stop as the Bengals try to dive inside. See if they go to the air now from the 1-yard line on third down.
Not doing much for Anderson's average, and now Anderson comes out, and he shows a little unhappiness as he does.
Chad Kay is now the lone back behind Rob Weta.
Movement. And the Broncos indicating that they think that the Bengals are guilty of the infraction, which would put them in a 3rd and 6 if it was indeed against ISU.
Bengals have had the ball a long time here. He started on their own 20-yard line.
On the offense, 5 yards.
So the penalty will move them back to the 6-yard line, and it'll still be third down.
We've got 79 yards in offense on this drive, and now they have 6 to go instead of 1 to get the touchdown.
Alfredo Anderson back in there at the tailback slot, and Weta will go from shotgun. Now he steps up under center. 12:05 left in the half. Anderson cuts it in, hit at the 5, and he's down right there. A lot of white jerseys around him.
Number 8 against number 8, and Brian Smith wins the battle that time.
Now decision time for Brian McNeely and the Bengal offensive brain trust as they try and determine whether to take the 3, the field goal attempt, or try to push it in on 4th and goal from the 6. And they send out James Farrell, who is...
He has only attempted one field goal this season. He was injured earlier in the season. He is 0-for-1.
He is a true freshman, and who had been doing the kicking is Eric Lenacci, a sophomore from Sweden. This one, he is good. 23-yarder, and with 11:21 remaining, the Bengals on the board again. Bronco lead cut to 21-10.
It's Blacker's 45th anniversary sale, and you'll find huge savings on the area's largest selection of America's name brand furniture, appliances, carpeting, and electronics.
Camcorders just $398, color TVs $158, Lazy Boys at $198. Plus, get two free airline tickets to Orlando, the Bahamas, Cancun, Mexico, or Hawaii with any purchase of $599 or more. 6 months same as cash, savings up to 70% during the 45th anniversary sale on now at Blackers, where you always buy for less.
We took the most comfortable full-size pickup on the road and made it more comfortable. We took the most thoughtful interior on the market and made it more thoughtful. We took the biggest cab in the industry and made it bigger. The new Dodge Ram Club Cab. First we changed the rules, then we stretched them. See all that's new at your friendly Northwest Dodge dealer.
Larry Vanilli and Tom Scott with you again from Pocatello. 11:21 remaining first half. Broncos up 21-10 on the Bengals. And James Farrell ready to kick it off to Willie Bowens, who has a 30-yard kick return average and ran 170 against Weber State last week. This one goes out of bounds inside the five, and the Broncos now will have the option of making Idaho State re-kick or taking the ball at the 35, and the offense is headed out.
I think they'll take it on the 35 and save the pain and duress of the special teams.
Well, and clearly Idaho State is not willing to kick the ball to Willie Bowens, so when you can get the ball at the 35-yard line, you got a great situation.
Here's the scoring drive, 15 plays, 74 yards, took 6.5 minutes, a long time on the field. For the Bronco defense, 23-yard field goal by Farrell brings Idaho State to within 11 as BSU starts on its own 35-yard line. Stacking in the backfield, and Zimmerman will go in motion.
Hole to the 40, a gain of 5.
Broncos on their last possession had a 15-yard drive after an Alfredo Anderson fumble. Their third touchdown of the night. Tony Hilde has thrown 2 TD passes.
Casey Adams with a 5-yard gain on his first carry of the second quarter had 127 yards total offense in the first quarter. That's on target for a whale of a football game.
And 2 touchdowns.
Second and 5. Hilde has some time, goes deep, overthrows Adams, who broke clear at the 40, but the ball was well over his head.
Hildy's got to be upset with himself. Casey Adams wide open because the Bengals were coming on a blitz and there was nobody left to cover KC. Brian Getz, the inside linebacker, was coming hard. He was picked up at the line of scrimmage, but ended up getting through and hurried the throw a little bit by Tony Hilde.
So now the Broncos with a 3rd and 5, they must convert in order to keep the drive alive. Good time for Hilde, complete to Jared Hauske across the 45, and that's good for the first down yardage.
Well, and that's what Hauske does so well. Great possession receiver, and he ran a perfect pattern that time. A curl just over the chains. Here's the a look at what happened in the first quarter in terms of yardage. 170 for Boise State, 89 for the Bengals. 1 turnover apiece, both converted to scores. Bengals have more first downs, but the Broncos have more big plays.
And the Bengals with 0 rushing yards in that first quarter. First down, Broncos. Casey Adams caught behind the line of scrimmage, and that's a play we've seen several times in the last couple of weeks as the Broncos use that to set up other plays, but they have consistently lost yardage with it.
They have now set up a 2nd and long. Now Brian Getz was blitzing that time, and they called the sweep right into Brian Getz's blitz, so 2nd and 15 is the result.
From the Bronco 40-yard line. Now Adams reversing to Akibi. Needs a block from Hilde and gets it. 45, 50, and fumbles. Idaho State's got it.
Second fumble in 2 weeks by Ryan Akibi.
Coming out of there with the football, Tom Prudhomme out of Pocatello's Highland High School. A co-captain, 6'2", 240-pound senior, number 95, makes the recovery.
Broncos want to get the ball into the hands of Ryan Akivi. They have a special list of Akivi plays, and this is one of them.
On the double block reverse.
Blocked there by,
block by Hildy.
Tony Hildy.
He had gotten most of it back and almost got a first down, but lost the ball on the hit. And the Bengals have the ball just inside Bronco territory.
Looked like Jarmaine Johns, number 43, a redshirt freshman out of Compton, California, who knocked the ball loose with the hit. Rob Weta now going deep on the far side to Romy Wheeler. Threw his hands, incomplete. Coverage by Rashid Gale.
May have had one put out of bounds anyway. The hook and go as Weta pump faked. But Rashid Gale did not bite on it. Good coverage by Gale. Broncos scored on that play 4 years ago from Mike Burden to Winky White. Got the same distance.
9:20 remaining second quarter. 21-10 Broncos. Bengals with a chance to take advantage of a Ryan Akivi fumble. Weta almost intercepted by Duan Miller.
The appeal for a flag is not going to work this time from Troy Waters. Threw it into double coverage that time. Jason Payne over there, along with Dewan Miller, and Chris Cook wasn't far away. Thomas Washington is in the game now for Alfredo Anderson at tailback. There you see the fake inside to Washington. Flushed out of the pocket by Joe O'Brien, and Dewan Miller gets a real good look at that ball.
Third and 10 from just inside Bronco territory. Weta to throw, getting a big rush from Sione Fifita, and Stephon Reed fell down, and big yardage for Thomas Washington inside the 30.
Sean Lawson, the junior from South Fremont High School in St. Anthony, threw the key block out there on the flat. The screen was not set up well, but they needed one block from Sean Lawson, number 72, and they get it. There it is right there, although...
the big disaster for Boise State was Stephon Reed losing his footing, and he's the cover man on the outside, and Washington went right by him to the Bronco 30. First down, Bengals, 9:04 left in the half.
Chad Kay
inside for a gain of 2.
Brian Smith stacks him up on the dive as the Broncos make situational changes now. The nickel comes in. Dewan Miller is the nickel back this week, replacing Tim Foley. And Chris Wing comes in as the rush defensive end, replacing Chris Shepard. So with Jairus King out this week, Joe O'Brien stays at right end instead of moving inside. And Travis Thompson and Sione Fifita are the tackles on long yardage situations.
Weta now stepping under center. Great start for him. 11 of 13, 120 yards. Thomas Washington, 20, 15, knocked down at the 14-yard line.
Great job on the left side of that Idaho State offensive line. Washington making a good read and cutting it back. A good block by number 74, Steve Mutsayers. Washington takes a hit from Keith Walk Green, but holds on to the ball, and Idaho State down at one time 21-7, now trailing by 11, threatening again.
First down Bengals at the Bronco 14. The left side of that offensive line, the Broncos thought they could take advantage of, coaching staff at least. Not the case so far, as they block well and open holes. And now Weta has to burn the Bengals' final timeout of the opening half. We'll take one as well. 7:49 remaining. A big possession for Idaho State with first down at the Bronco 14.
Wow. What's on everybody's mind right now? Football, big guys, big thrills, big fun. But don't just think tailgate parties. Think tailgate sweepstakes. Coach Kelly's tailgate sweepstakes going on right now. Enter today. You could win a $500 gift certificate from Lands and or other great prizes. And they are terrific. Of course, so are the good deals you'll find on Great Kelly Tires. So get your tailgate to your Kelly dealer today and enter Coach Kelly's tailgate sweepstakes. Don't pass this one up.
Blind date at Chili's. How about some buffalo wings?
Says appetizer. Lets her know a guy like me won't wait around forever.
Maybe I'll get the chicken Caesar salad.
That way I'll be light on my feet if we go dancing later.
Ah, I see they have grilled chicken pasta with vegetables.
Sophisticated. Says to where I don't wear a clip-on tie. Tells her I can work a corkscrew.
I like this guy. He really has his act together.
Uh-oh. I think I locked my keys in the car.
Idaho State Bengals with a first and 10 at the Bronco 14-yard line as they try to fight back from an early 14-point deficit after recovering a fumble inside Bronco territory. Ryan Akibi fumbling on the reverse. Highland High grad Tom Prudhomme recovering for ISU. Thomas Washington tripped up and falling to the line of scrimmage. Look like Chris Wing and Keith Walk Green in on the tackle. Second and 10.
Slow developing play as Washington comes out and Anderson back in now. Wholesale substitutions right now by Idaho State on second and 10.
Bengals out of timeouts, but with plenty of clock, 7:20 in the half.
Maybe with the no huddle, they don't bother running the play clock because the play clock is not operating.
Weta gets pressure, rolls away from it, and runs it out of bounds at the 15-yard line. 16, actually. He'll lose a yard and a half. And it'll be third and 10, 11.
Chance to cut it in and get more yardage on that. That's a coverage, credit to the coverage. As we look at the Chili scoreboard, Idaho holding on against Montana State, 27-13 in the Kibbe Dome. Broncos play Montana State next week in Bozeman.
And the Bobcats had a chance to take the lead with 3 minutes left and threw an interception in the end zone. Weber State a winner at Southern Utah, so the Wildcats get back on track.
Big play here.
Third and 12 from the 16-yard line. Weta gets a big rush, and the pass is dropped by Romy Wheeler. And the Bengals now will have to settle, it would appear, for a field goal attempt on fourth and 12.
Simply a drop by Romy Wheeler. They had the middle screen set up, although Rasheed Gale was in position to stop it for very little gain. So Farrell will come back after hitting a 23-yarder to pull the Bengals to within 11. Farrell now one of two on the season.
Kirk Clifford out of Centennial High and Meridian is the holder. It's a fake, and that's Kirk Clifford, 20, 15, to the 10, to the 5-yard line.
He is short.
Short of the first down, depending on the spot.
They're spotting it at the 5-yard line, and the Broncos will take over.
So that's a fake all the way. You saw the stutter by Farrell, and here comes Kirk Clifford, the sophomore out of Centennial High. Chris Cook stands his ground, and it's a good spot. He rolled to the 14, but he hit at the 4-yard line. He hit at the 5.
The ball sits exactly where it touched the ground when Clifford went down, so the Broncos dodged the proverbial bullet. The Bengals had a chance to pull within 8. Broncos now 95 yards away from the end zone, leading 21-10 with 7 minutes left in the half. Broncos do not go with their goal line offense.
Hildy gives to Casey Adams, who will lose a yard.
Brought down by Alapate Taualupe, junior college transfer from Pitt Hills JC in California. Big Hawaiian out of Honolulu. As you get a look at Casey, Taualupe was recruited by Boise State during that mad rush of junior college visits in December. Ended up coming to Idaho State.
Look at some more scores. Great football game down at the Swamp. Auburn knocking off number one ranked Florida. Nebraska, likely to take the top spot if the Tigers don't get it. Here we are on second and 11. Hildy to throw and completed. Ryan Akibi out across the 16-yard line for the first down.
Boy, if Akibi had been able to keep his feet, he had a lot of green ahead of him. But Hildy had to hurry his throw a little bit. He was decked just after releasing the ball by defensive end Tom Prudhoe. Still a first down for the Broncos. Outside their 21.
More scores from across the nation. Penn State wins the Big Ten showdown with a fourth quarter touchdown at Michigan. A&M beats Baylor. Washington clobbers Arizona State. Another tough day for Jake Plummer, Capital High grad and quarterback for ASU. Under 6 minutes and a half here. Hildy with the pump fake and takes it forward for a gain of a yard.
Hildy saw something he liked. He thought he had single coverage with Ryan Akibi. He tried to pump fake to Akibi. Nothing doing there. Didn't have time to look for a secondary receiver and had to turn it up.
Alabama and Tennessee tied at 3 in the second. Colorado State with a big win. And the Rams figure to gain some more ground. Arizona leading Washington State in the third quarter up in Pullman. North Carolina wins over Maryland. Broncos with 2nd and 9 here in Pocatello, leading 21-10 late in the first half. Hildy tucks it 20 to the 25-yard line. That'll be a yard short of the first down.
See what the Broncos do on third and short if they bring their short yardage offense in with the double tights. Tony had the option to run here all the way, and he was thinking it all the way. His first look was to Akibi, who came in motion out of the backfield, and then he turned it up to a gain of about 7.
And the Broncos will use one of their timeouts. They will have 2 remaining when we return. 4:38 in the half. Boise State with 3rd and a long yard.
Come on.
I want to beat you, Daddy.
If you're going to spend extra time on something,
Daddy,
spend it with your best friend, not paying bills. Call 1-800-US-BANKS.
Hi, I'm Dennis Combs from Combs Car Corral. Need a new car or truck? Afraid of being turned down? Afraid of high interest rates? Embarrassed of your past credit history? Stop. Combs Car Corral finances anyone. That's right, anyone. With 3 locations, Fairview, Boise, the Boulevard in Nampa, and in Homedale, we have over 300 cars and trucks to choose from. The lowest prices and the best interest rates. Good credit, bad credit, bankruptcy? It doesn't matter. We finance anyone at Combs Car Corral.
You see the time and score. The rest of this situation is 3rd and less than 2 for the Broncos at their 25-yard line. In motion, Bernie Zimmerman. Casey Adams to the 28, almost 29-yard line. Good for the first down, and the Broncos will keep the ball, and the clock will continue to roll.
Casey elected not to leap over the top that time. As he saw some daylight, he wanted to get more than just the 3 yards he got for the Bronco first down.
Ball at the 28. It is a first down. 4:20 in the half.
As much as ISU's had the ball here in the second period, the Broncos would like to put together a long drive.
Pump fake. Hildy caught in, or excuse me, Akibi caught in the backfield and will lose 3 yards.
And had he not caught that, that would have been a lateral and would have been a fumble a la last week against Weber State. So a good job of hanging on to the ball by Akibi. To see BYU upsetting Notre Dame in South Bend today, 21-14.
Virginia Tech a winner at East Carolina after trailing 2019 late. Utah remains undefeated with an 11-point win over Hawaii in Salt Lake.
Rainy Salt Lake today.
2nd and 14, Broncos from the 24. Hildy on the roll, looks deep, and there is Housky wide open. Makes the catch at the 35. going all the way? No. Caught inside the 10 and dragged down at the 6-yard line.
There's a flag at the line of scrimmage.
And the indication is it'll come back on a holding call against Boise State.
Oh, what a great throw, Tony Hilde.
He laid that ball out there perfectly, and Hauschke just ran under it.
Boy, he had a huge lane out there, too, which may have been helped by the hold. I'm talking about Hilde. Hilde had time and room to roam had he not decided to throw.
3:22 left in the half, and the Broncos set back a little. And sorry, we don't have a good look at the holding call, so we won't burden you with an inconsequential replay. But, boy, what a great throw that time by Tony Hilde. So the 10-yard penalty moves it back to the 14-yard line.
It's from the point of infraction, which was at the 24. So it is second down.
The Broncos have to get to the 38. Second and 24. Casey Adams dragged down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made by
Ta'ualupe.
295-pound junior.
He's having a good game against a team he could have played for. Randy Mattishaw comes in. Michael Richmond comes out for the Broncos.
Third and 24. Broncos have had some success tonight so far, but they've got their work cut out on this one. Everybody out in a pattern. Hilde with time has a Kibi at the 33, short of the first down. But some punting room for Danny Weeks.
Important punting room with 2:07 remaining in the half.
Bengals with no timeouts, and certainly they are relieved just to get the ball back after the Broncos had appeared to have put together a tremendous scoring opportunity. Danny Weeks now to kick it away. Gets a good snap and taken at the 23-yard line, and big contact.
Chris Wing got him along with Jason Payne. Bengals with decent field position, though, at the 34-yard line. They'll have a minute 37 to work with. The Broncos have allowed the Bengals to hang around here through some BSU errors and turnovers. And it's a ball game. Weta comes in with Alfredo Anderson and Chad Kay will be the running backs.
A minute 37, and again, Idaho State with no timeouts, so they'll have to use the sideline unless they hit something deep. And now the play clock finally ran for the first time, and for some reason, the officials decided to stop it and reset it. First time in some time it has operated.
Yes.
Weta, short toss. And didn't get out of bounds. That's Chad Kay, official. The Bengal assistant coach is up here screaming for him to get out of bounds. He didn't get it done. Clock continues to run at 1:20.
An advantage for the Bengals in the no huddle here.
Second and 3. Weta. Deep tipped by Brian Smith. Incomplete. That'll stop the clock with 1:08. And the Bengals will have it 3rd and 3 from their 41-yard line.
Steve Butsayer's number 74 working against Chris Wing, saving him from the rush, saving Weta from the rusher. Wing shaken up a little bit on that play. There's the tip by Smith, and Wheeler was open in front of Chris Cook momentarily.
Wheeler was then flattened by Chris Cook. 3rd and 3. Weta with the play fake to Alfredo Anderson, then deep down the sideline, incomplete. Cook pulled up after the hit, and it'll be 4th down for the Bengals.
And the Broncos will get the ball back
with 2 timeouts and a minute 3.
Only 34 seconds on that ISU possession. So that will bring James Farrell into punt, as you mentioned, averaging under 36 yards a punt this season.
Well, and it shows you the importance of thinking and keeping a presence of mind and the stuff that drives coaches crazy. When Chad Kay didn't get out of bounds, it cost the Bengals most of that 30 seconds. Sure, Casey Adams is going to let that one hit the ground, and it takes a sideways bounce out of bounds at the Bronco 33-yard line. So with 56 seconds left, they will have a great opportunity. Tom Scott headed to the sideline for a quick interview with Pokey Allen on his way to the Bronco locker room. Big rush, eludes it, ducks it in, and to the 37-yard line. Clock continues to run at 45 seconds. Broncos quickly back to the line. The ball is set. Lake Lock now is running at 20 seconds. 33, 32, 31 left in the half. Hildy to throw. Casey Adams. And if they have anything in mind, they're going to have to use a timeout here, as Hildy to Adams is good for the first down to the 45-yard line. Clock will stop while the chains move, but the Broncos can also use a timeout should they choose, and they do. So they'll have one timeout remaining. Timeout. 22 seconds left in the half. The Broncos 55 yards from the end zone. Probably need to get about 30 to put Greg Erickson in range. Tomorrow morning, NFL Live at 10:30, and then at 11, the Raiders and Miami. And I don't know if you caught any of the skills challenge this afternoon, but some of golf's greats, Chichi Rodriguez, Gary Player, Peter Jacobson, in a skills challenge. Driving for accuracy. Tony Hildy is 9 of 11 for 156 yards and two touchdowns so far, a long gainer of 59. A reminder that Sisters, normally seen at 9, and we're just coming up on 8 o'clock, will be seen in its entirety tomorrow night, 11:30, after Bronco Spotlight with Pokey Allen. Back to live action now. Broncos with a first down at their 45 and just 22 seconds left. Hildy wants to go deep, cross the line of scrimmage to the 50, and has a first down to the Bengal 44. Penalty flag in the Bronco backfield. Another at the line where Hildy went down. Maybe offsetting penalties. We'll have to wait and see. They're dropped 15 yards apart. Bengals, some of the Bengals indicated to this near sideline a penalty against the Broncos. Hildy did just the opposite.
Holding, offense, 5-yard face mask, defense, penalties offset, replay the down.
So the net loss is the Broncos lose 8 seconds off the clock, and they will go again first down from their 45-yard line. 14 seconds remaining in the half. Hildy brings him up with three wide receivers to the near side. Michael Richmond at the top of the screen. Kibi Howski and Schrack closest to you at the bottom of the screen. First and 10. That's Richmond, 35-30, down the sideline, out of bounds inside the 20. Marked just outside the 20. Great cut out by Mike Richmond, and he's got Greg Erickson in range, but the clock had expired. And the Broncos not happy with that situation. trying to plead their case for one more play, but they won't get it. Tom Scott is awaiting Pokey Allen's journey to the locker room, and it may be delayed because he's not happy with the sequence of events at the end of that half. It did not appear that 14 seconds could elapse in a 35-yard play by a guy who runs a 5-flat or less 40, but the time is gone and the scoring opportunity with it. So the Broncos take a 21-10 lead into the locker room at halftime. And Pokey Allen just about to make his way over to Tom Scott. Let's go to the sideline now and hear what the Bronco coach has to say about the first 30 minutes.
Pokey, long, shortest 13 seconds I've ever seen there at the end of the first half.
Well, we're playing in Pocatello, but whatever. We got to quit making mistakes, fumbling the ball, making a few mistakes. We hadn't made those mistakes. They can't stop us, so we could score a lot of points. They're running pretty good on offense, but I think we got some adjustments we'll work.
Defensively, what can you do to adjust to the effectiveness so far of Rob Wedham?
Well, they're running a lot of play-action passes and getting us tied up. They're not running the ball. I think we're fine. It's not a matter. They just got some short field positions and got some scores. We'll be okay.
What do you say to the offense at halftime?
They just got to quit making mistakes. They can score at will. All they have to do is quit making mistakes.
Okay, see you after the game, Poke. Head coach Pokey Allen. As the Broncos lead the Bengals here at halftime at Holt Arena, 21-10. We'll be back with Larry Manili upstairs right after this.
The KTVB Halftime Report, brought to you by Lee Reed Jewelers. When you think diamonds, think Lee Reed, Idaho's diamond jeweler. And Idatran Freight Systems. Idatran, we're Idahoans serving Idaho. The advantage of using the Idatran Freight System is obvious. We deliver to all the major cities. We also handle the out-of-the-way shipments turned down by other carriers. In fact, we deliver...
And the return man is in Kiasen to the near side, 20, 25, runs out of real estate at the 37-yard line.
Idaho State had a wall set up on the left side as the Broncos were pouring down the middle. Nikiasen hit it, and the Bengals start in good field position at their own 37. Anderson and Kay will be the running backs, as Weta still conferring on the sideline and now comes in for the no huddle.
Bengals start at their 37-yard line, trailing 21-10. Kirk Clifford, the Centennial High grad, wide at the top of the screen. Weta comes to the near side, has Wheeler across the 50, a first down at the Boise State 45-yard line.
Weta has only been sacked once tonight. He's getting a lot of time as he works out of the shotgun. It's a gain of 18 yards. Here you see the time that Weta has. Nobody comes close to touching him, and that allows Wheeler to run another underneath route, get the ball down to the BSU 45.
Again from the shotgun formation. Now Weta up under center. Hands to Kay inside for a gain of two. And a little scuffle on the near sideline between Jason Payne and Romy Wheeler, each restrained by an official and pointed back to their huddle. And in fact, in Wheeler's case, he comes to the sideline.
They do not want any personal fouls tonight. We had the parade of them at Northern Arizona 2 weeks ago.
Second and eight Bengals from the Bronco 43. Play fake to Alfredo Anderson. Weta gets a rush. Now throws, penalty flag thrown in the Bengal backfield, most likely for a hold. Siona Fifita, in fact, pointing at the spot of the infraction. He was the guy whose jersey was grabbed big time, I think.
Stephon Reed with good coverage on Josh Gibbs. Gibbs improvised his route and came back, but simply dropped the ball. It's going to be academic anyway as the hold call is signaled against the Bengals. So it should be 10 yards from the spot of the foul, which will take it all the way back to the 39.
Look at Fafita. He's trying to break free and can't get loose. And the flag came from about 10 yards upfield, an official who had the basic same vantage point we did.
And that's what allowed Weta the time to throw the ball to Josh Gibbs. You couldn't have asked for a better throw.
Holding offense from the flag, 10 yards. Repeat, second down.
So the line of scrimmage was the Bronco 43. The point of infraction was the Bengal 48. That ball now back to the ISU 38-yard line.
Second and 27. So the Broncos bring Chris Wing in the passing situation. DeJuan Miller is in at right corner now in place of Jason Payne.
Alfredo Anderson breaks containment and tackled by Tim Foley, who has to come up and help out after a 10-yard gain.
Brian Smith forced him to fumble out of bounds at the end of the play. Easily the longest carry of the night for Alfredo Anderson, just over 10 yards outside the 48-yard line. Broncos want to get set here on defense, although ISU still signaling the play in, but ISU has the ability to quick snap and to snap without a cadence.
Third and 17. Big down early in the third quarter for the Bengals. Romy Wheeler makes the catch, breaks a tackle at the 30, and now brought down by DeJuan Miller, but not until after he picks up a first down.
That ball was overthrown. A great catch there by Romy Wheeler. What a good time once again as the Broncos. Looked like Fafita was hooked there, but a shoulder tackle doesn't work by Keith Watt Green, and it's DeJuan Miller who has to stop him, and the Bengals got out of a second and 27 hole with a first down on the BSU 30-yard line.
Weta checking off now. Changing the play at the line of scrimmage. In motion is Anderson. Weta goes over the middle. A penalty flag in the secondary. Pass caught for a 3-yard gain by Kirk Clifford.
There are flags on either side of the field. The attendance tonight, the largest crowd since BSU was here 2 years ago. Penalty is against Boise State. Didn't see the call. Probably a defensive hold.
And that'll be from the line of scrimmage. 10 yards.
Illegal participation. Too many.
Illegal participation.
Oh,
first
my.
Down.
Too many players on the field. A 15-yard penalty. First down Bengals at the Bronco 15-yard line. And that's the kind of stuff that has coaches pulling their hair out.
Pokey doesn't have much left. He'll be the first to tell you.
12 and a half remaining in the third quarter. 21-10 Broncos. Bengals trying to get back in it. Alfredo Anderson. A little move on Chris Cook, who drags him out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Spotted at the 9, actually. Second and 4.
Vince Watson had a chance at Alfredo in the backfield. Sean Larson was able to hold his block just long enough to allow Alfredo to hit the outside. So 6 yards on first down. The Bengals will take that every time. ISU's first possession of the third period. They trail by 11.
Second and 4. Play fake. Pass caught. And Troy Waters of Pocatello High diving to the 1, first and goal.
That was a great catch by Troy Waters and a great play action fake by Rob Weta. They're playing older than their years, as you see the play fake here to Alfredo Anderson. That froze the Broncos momentarily, and a quick delivery by Rob Weta. Keith Watt Green keeps him out of the end zone. First and goal at the 1.
First catch of the night from Waters, who came in among the leading receivers on the team. Alfredo Anderson knocked off his feet. No gain. Might have lost a half yard. It'll be second and goal. We're at the 12-minute mark. Timeout.
Officials timeout.
Perhaps someone's shaken up, and
It might be Alfredo. The only guy not standing is number 8, Alfredo Anderson. There you see him.
He took a pretty good shot. You know, I'm not sure whether you could see it on the in the camera angle that we had on screen, but he was knocked sideways at the point of contact.
32 yards now. He's got 15 net in the second half.
Take another look on replay as you see Anderson try to dive for the touchdown.
Ooh, there's one hit. No, it didn't look particularly vicious.
Right on
the
hip.
He hit hard on his left hip.
Looked like Vince Watson got him on the hip with his shoulder.
And he came down hard on the turf with his left hip as well.
So Anderson, the Big Sky Offensive Player of the Week last week, comes out, replaced by Thomas Washington, number 1. And it's second and goal Bengals from the Bronco 1. Washington, no gain, maybe lost another half yard.
Obvious reason for that, Weta tripped as he was making the handoff. Weta took a step back and tripped. I don't know if he tripped over his center's foot, but made it difficult for Washington to get that handoff.
Good hit by Stephon Reed.
First man there. Stephon Reed having a great game.
Third and goal, and the Bengals not advancing the football so far.
Probably in two down territory here, unless the ball's backed up.
Weta going to the end zone. Touchdown Bengals. Romy Wheeler. He put that ball right on the money, and there's nothing Rasheed Gale could do.
Romy Wheeler ran a crossing pattern, then came back to the goal line, caught it in front of Rasheed Gale inside the end zone. The Bengals are really hanging around now.
21-16, and I'm not sure whether the Bengals will go for two and make it a three-point game. Really, there's no advantage to being down by four.
They're going for two, Weta, in the no huddle out of the shotgun.
Clifford in motion. Penalty flag. Clifford makes the catch, but there is a flag at the line of scrimmage.
It's against Idaho State.
That'll cost them 5.
Illegal procedure.
And now the question will be whether they continue to go for the two-point attempt or send the kicking unit on.
Weta stays in the game for the time being, and Chad Kay looked like he came in with the play. They're putting it now, marking it off on the left hash.
Not enough men on the line, on the offense, 5 yards.
Now Weta comes for a quick check with Brian McNeely. As the play clock still does not start, now it does. Now they whistled the play in, a late whistle. They almost huddled. Idaho State almost huddled.
They've gone with a no huddle 95% of the evening. Here's the two-point conversion now from the 8. Weta throwing to the end zone. Incomplete, and the Bengals miss. And they want a flag, and so does the crowd, but no flag thrown. Weta pleading his case to no avail. 11-16 remaining, third quarter. Broncos lead cut to 5.
Blacker's 45th anniversary sale is on now, and prices have been drastically reduced on entire stocks of inventory. Anniversary discounts from Sony, RCA, GE, Maytag, Whirlpool, Amana, Lazy Boy, Broyhill, Sealy, and more. Plus, get 2 free airline tickets to Orlando, the Bahamas, Cancun, Mexico, or Hawaii with any purchase of $599 or more. 6 months same as cash, savings up to 70% during the 45th anniversary sale on now at Blacker's, where you always buy for less.
It's time for friends to fly free on Southwest Airlines.
Wake up and smell the coffee.
And people are friendlier than ever. Just make reservations at least a day in advance and buy your round-trip ticket at Southwest's regular low unrestricted fare, and a friend flies with you, free, anywhere we fly.
Yo! Dad, what do you think?
Friends fly free on Southwest, the low-fare airline. Call 1-800-IFLY-SWA.
The Idaho State Bengals have just taken the opening possession of the third quarter and driven to a touchdown, missed a two-point conversion attempt, and trail Boise State now only 21-16. Kickoff skidding to a stop and picked up by Willie Bowens across the 15 out to the 19-yard line, where the Broncos will have it on offense for their first possession of this third quarter.
Goal of any special teams unit to keep the opponent inside the 20-yard line. And Idaho State, the obvious strategy, not to let Willie Bowens get a running start at the ball. Bowens had to pick it up on the ground after the ISU coverage had reached him. So the Broncos, with not great field position, leading now only by five.
63 yards in 11 plays. Weddita Wheeler officially 2 yards on the touchdown pass. Almost 5 minutes off the clock. Hildy now trying to answer for Boise State. Across the middle, got his tight end. Is that Matashock? Out across the 35 for a first down.
You heard Pokey Allen right before halftime. You know that he feels that the Broncos can move the ball, and they did to the tune of 267 yards in the first half. Just mistakes and defensive letdowns have let the Broncos stay in this ball game. The play fake and the pass to Matashock, who had his best game of his senior college career last week.
Well, he is a load when he's in the open field like that, too. First down Broncos at the 35-yard line. Hildy with the pump. Oh, had Lee Schrack, and he couldn't hang on. Got Schrack between defenders, and the ball came skidding through.
Threw it a little bit behind him. Schrack, the great story. Came to Boise State as a junior college transfer quarterback last year. Was shifted to tight end when he was taken out of the quarterback rotation late last year. Moved to wide receiver in the spring and played himself into the lineup.
And has been a major contributor with 11 catches and a touchdown coming in. Hildy over the 200-yard mark in pass completions now. With a pump fake going deep out the far sideline. Jared Howski into Bengal territory, stepped out of bounds. First down, Broncos at the ISU 38.
Great execution by Hildy and Howski on the hook and go. Great pump fake by Tony Hildy. This is Hildy's eighth 200-yard game of his young career.
And he's well on the way to 300. That's about 25 more right there.
He only has one 300 game, and that was in his debut last year at Montana. Boy, Bengals bit on the pump fake, and Broncos want to put some distance between themselves and the Bengals here.
Casey Adams straight up the middle inside the 30 to the 25. First down, Broncos.
Casey's first carry of the second half. He gets 12 and he has 63 on the night. Casey Adams, 5 of the 6 Bronco games, he's been over 100 yards. And the 6th, the Nevada game, he had 99.
So Dave Castro seeing some action there, a 5'9 sophomore out of San Diego wearing number 91. Making his first road trip, want to mention that for his friends back on campus who might be watching. He saw action. Hildy got lots of room. 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown Broncos.
Oh.
Tony Hildy at his best.
A 25-yard run. Almost identical to the run he made last year, although last year's run was on an option, his long touchdown run against Idaho State. This year on a pass play where everything was covered, and Alapate Taualupe is down on the field and officials timeout called. Hildy's second rushing touchdown of the season, and he has 44 yards on the night.
Well, he just plowed through the last 3 or 4 defenders inside the 10-yard line. When he decided to go, he had nothing but green turf in front of him.
Great job by Steve Brushy, and a great fan block that time by John Miller. John Miller took the defender all the way out of the play, and look at that move by Hildy. He's tough. Breaks the tackle.
Josh Brown had a shot at the 2-yard line, but it was too little and way too late.
Hildy with Greg Erickson waiting for Taualupe, who is okay, to leave the field. 81-yard drive by Boise State, and a very crisp one.
So the Broncos answer the Bengal touchdown. Erickson trying to provide the conversion out of Hildy's hold. Everything works to perfection. 9:53 left in the third quarter. Bronco lead at a dozen now, 28-16.
Over the years, Western Trophy has been beside you as you've celebrated your victories and saluted your accomplishments by providing the finest in hand, computerized, and laser-engraved awards. From trophies for your future superstar to advertising specialties, from professional honors to every corporate incentive imaginable, we're with you all the way. Western Trophy and Engraving. For the winners since 1964 at 5529 Overland Road.
We gave Dodge Ram the most powerful overall line of truck engines on the planet. A driver's side airbag. The option of four-wheel anti-lock brakes. A cab designed to set the standard for comfort and room. Then, after we made Ram that good, we made it this bad. Introducing the new Ram Sport.
See all that's new at your friendly Northwest Dodge dealer.
Larry Manili and Tom Scott with you again. Just under 10 minutes left, third quarter. Teams have traded touchdowns in the first two possessions since intermission. Broncos adding a conversion. Bengals failing after a two-point attempt. So it's a 12-point game at 28-16. Greg Erickson kicking it off now to Kennedy Nkiasin. Well back into the end zone. He will touch it down, and ISU will start from their 20-yard line.
As you recall, ISU got a kickoff return last time and started on their 37. And now it's time for the Bronco defense to respond. The Bronco defense has been a little hot and cold tonight. Five plays, 81-yard drive, and that's exactly how the Broncos wanted to start the third period. Tony Hildy's 25-yard run, capping it in only a minute and 23 seconds.
And now Rob Weta trying to answer again for the Idaho State Bengals.
They've got Romy Wheeler on Stephon Reed.
And Weta wants him quick. No, he's going to the far side to Kirk Clifford. Rashid Gale had the best shot at it. Almost got his Big Sky leading sixth interception. But the ball falls harmless, and it'll be second and 10.
Wheeler was open off the bat.
Yes, he was. He ran right and by Stephon Gale.
A timing throw would have hit him, but Weta looking all the way for Kirk Clifford out of Centennial High. Clifford, a 1,000-yard rusher in 1989 for the Patriots.
Second and 10 Bengals. Weta from shotgun formation. Big throw right to Chris Cook to the 30, 25, and the Broncos have the big turnover that could open this game.
Broncos finally got some pressure that time on Rob Weta, and it paid off. That was Weta's first really bad throw of the night.
That was badly overthrown.
Cook's second interception this season. And second of his career as Joe O'Brien was collapsing in on him.
Cook just waiting like an outfielder for a fly ball to come down at the 38. Ran it back to the 25-yard line. First down Broncos. Hildy to Casey Adams. A gain of about three.
Stop made there by Ossie Violetti, a freshman, a true freshman, All-State player last year in Hawaii. 5'11", 275, got a real low center of gravity. On this ISU team, 21 freshmen and sophomores on the two deep, including a number of true freshmen.
Second and seven now from the Bengal 21-yard line. Hildy. Housky knocked out of bounds at the 17.
Quick drop by Tony Hildy that time. The Broncos shuffling on the offensive line. On this series, Keith Jeffrey and Martez Benes are on the left. Good protection that time. designed to get close to the first down, which it does. It'll be third and three.
The Kibbe to the far side. Hauske slotted inside Lee Schreck at the near side. And Adams, of course, the setback behind Hilde. Gets a rush and has to release it. It's an incompletion. And Greg Erickson will come on to try to boot a field goal.
Broncos with a touchdown on this possession could have made things really difficult on Idaho State. Instead, they will have to try to settle for three from Greg Erickson, and it won't be a short kick. It'll be about a 39-yarder with an angle right.
Check at 34.
All right, 34. Still short.
Hilde will hold, but you've seen the consistency that Erickson has displayed, and he's got a strong leg. Bengals jumping around, and they want to be careful because the Broncos only needed 3 yards for the first.
He nails it.
Field goal would have been good from 50. It still counts only three, and the Broncos, with 8:45 in the third, have opened up a 15-point advantage.
Did you have your music turned up way too loud once upon a time? Who knows what it did to your hearing? Audio Hearing Aid Center can tell you with a free hearing evaluation. If we find you need help, no one ever needs to know. The new technology in hearing aids makes them virtually invisible, and 25 years in the Treasure Valley means experience in finding the right one for you. Audio Hearing Aid Center in the Parkway Professional Center on Veterans Parkway, 2 blocks south of State Street. Hear the 90s as well as you heard the 60s and 70s.
My wife says I look great since I've been working out twice a week.
I've been working out every day.
Luckily, I just discovered Chili's Guiltless Grill.
Really? I knew about it months ago.
Good. Every dish is really low in fat. My Guiltless Veggie Pasta with fresh tomato sauce has only 11 grams of fat.
Oh, yeah? Well, my Guiltless Chicken Salad with Southwest Dressing has only 3 grams of fat.
I walked here.
I jogged.
I was going uphill.
I was going against the wind.
I was carrying weight.
I was wearing really heavy sweats.
Larry Manili and Tom Scott with you again from Pocatello, where the Broncos have used a 34-yard field goal by Greg Erickson, boosting their lead to 31-16. Erickson's kick now wandering around at the one-yard line and finally crossing the goal line, where Kennedy and Kiasen touches his knee, and the Bengals will start from the 20. That ball had the dangerous look of one that might turn and come back toward the 5 and stay in the field of play.
Broncos only got 8 yards after the Chris Cook interception, but Greg Erickson cashes in with a 34-yard field goal to put the Broncos up 31-16, 52 seconds of possession. So Broncos have had 2 scoring drives of a minute 23 and under a minute.
They played just over 6 minutes, had the ball twice, and added 10 points to their total. Thomas Washington, and he is caught in the backfield, a loss of 2. Joe O'Brien and Travis Thompson combining on the tackle. Mark forward progress to the 19, so a loss of 1.
Nowhere to go this time. Penetration by both O'Brien and Thompson. First man to get there is Thompson. O'Brien had a chance at a face mask there and wisely just grazed it. Did not grasp.
Second and 11, Bengals. Weta now with some trouble and throws it up for grabs. Dewan Miller makes the catch, but he lands out of bounds. Boy, he played that ball absolutely as well as you could.
And Dewan Miller, he doesn't like people to talk about it, but what a great athlete, and how he makes acrobatic catches like that with only one arm.
Born with an arm that ends at the elbow, and he has made himself into a major college football player. He is a terrific athlete and really a nice guy. Fun to visit with.
Now that's where, when you're a true freshman, that's where it comes into play when you throw a ball up for grabs like that.
Bad decision by Rob Weta. He escaped disaster by about 1 yard. Weta now gets pressure, dumps it off to Chad Kay across the 20, fights his way to the 25, where he's driven out of bounds by Stephon Reed and Chris Cook, but the Bengals will have to punt.
Well, the Bronco defense had to respond after the Bronco touchdown. After ISU got one of their own to start the third period, and two nice jobs on the last two Idaho State possessions.
And a partisan Boise State, 1,000 down to our lower right, stand and applaud the Bronco defense as they leave the field.
Casey Adams standing only 35 yards downfield from the line of scrimmage, trying to get a beat on John Farrell here.
James Farrell kicking it away, and Adams at the 40, straight up field, 45, 50, breaks a tackle, 45, outside, had a chance. Shoestring tackle keeps him from going the distance, and that was, Josh Brown.
You could hear the 1,000 Bronco fans to our right here going, oh, because they knew there was one man left to beat for Casey Adams.
He was about to find daylight on the outside. So the Broncos, 7:43 left in the third quarter. Trying to add to the offensive total now.
Broncos will take this field position most certainly on the 40.
Hilly rolling, rolled right into a tackler, and there really wasn't much that Martez Bemis could do to protect him because he rolled away from Bemis.
Bemis's assignment was to fan, and Alapate Tuolupe just made a great move inside, anticipating Tony Hilde, and Hilde is sacked, if only for a yard.
Let's check in with the Chili scoreboard. Northern Arizona up on Eastern Washington, 21-0 in the third down in Flagstaff. Arizona has knocked off Washington State in a battle for control of the Pac-10 lead.
Did you expect a score higher than that?
Not in Pullman with the weather like it's been in the Northwest. Hilde now going deep down the middle. Hadley Schreck underthrew it. Pass intercepted by Brian Bethel, who brings it back across the 35.
Broncos could have put the game away.
Ryan Akibi makes the tackle. Lee Schreck was behind the defense, and Hilde underthrew him.
That's only Tony's fifth interception of the year against 16 touchdowns. Plenty of time here. And Hilde had this one. He needed to put more loft on the ball to get it over. Schreck had the man beat.
Bethel, a junior, 6-foot junior, 195-pounder out of Colorado Springs, runs it right back to good field position for the Bengals at their own 36-yard line now, as the teams struggle to find out who's going to take control here. That one incomplete.
Tione Fifita with the pressure that time.
Intended for Josh Gibbs. A few more scores. Purdue surprising Wisconsin with a 27-all tie in the Big Ten.
That hurts the Badgers.
Boston College wins big over Temple. Duke over Clemson. The Dukies remain undefeated. Second and 10 here. Handoff inside to Kennedy and Kaysen out across the 50. And where has Alfredo Anderson disappeared to? Perhaps the hip injury more serious than we might have thought.
Well, it was Thomas Washington on the last possession, and now Kennedy Nikaiason. It's only his sixth carry of the season and by far his longest run.
He came into the game, in fact, with 14 yards net rushing and picked up 15 on that one.
Broncos with three turnovers tonight. ISU with two.
Weta with a lot of time. Almost overthrew Gibbs, but he makes the catch at the Bronco 38, and the Bengals moving the football.
See Pete Kwiatkowski upset on the far sideline watching the defensive line at work. Weta with plenty of time once again. Kwiatkowski may be bemoaning a possible hold in there, but he's not happy with the pressure that line's getting on Weta right now.
Stephon Reed and Chris Cook combining on that last tackle, approaching the 6-minute mark here in the third quarter. I have a feeling the scoring has only just begun here in the second half. Weta with time. Pass caught. And that's Sam Carter out of Tallahassee, Florida.
Very suddenly, the Bengals move right downfield. Just when you thought Weta was starting to hear footsteps a little bit, Weta catches fire once again.
And for the third week in a row, the Broncos, with a chance to put a team away, had the ball in scoring territory themselves. In fact, had a man breaking open at the goal line. Pass underthrown, ball intercepted.
opposition right back in your face and a chance to tighten the game up again. Weta hands inside to Nkayasin. Inside the 15, another ISU first down at the 12-yard line.
Little handoff out of the shotgun as the Broncos were thinking pass and bringing everybody. A great call. Once Nkayasin got past the front wall.
He's a 5'10", 170-pound, true freshman, born in Ghana, raised in Regina, Saskatchewan, Canada.
And he's still learning football.
He's learning. He's a quick study. Weta has Romy Wheeler to the one. Jason Payne gambled on the interception and missed.
Idaho State, when it looked like they were down, have just sliced right through the Bronco defense.
First and goal.
potential 80-yard drive now chewed up by Idaho State.
Actually, the drive will be 64 because he returned the interception out to the 36-yard line.
Correct.
First down, gaining just half a yard.
Thinking of the last kickoff return. Weta doesn't carry the ball intentionally very often. He did that time on the keeper over right guard, and Broncos stacked it up as Brian McNeely looks on. 3-8 and 2-9 in his first two seasons at ISU. Thomas Washington back in at running back for the Bengals.
Second and goal inside the one. Weta moves up under center, another quarterback keeper. Short again, and it'll be third and goal. And I must say, not much imagination on ISU's offensive coaching staff inside the 5-yard line in their last couple of possessions.
Well, you've got a healthy Thomas Washington in there who's got leaping ability.
Well, you've got great speed as well, whether you've got Nkayasin, whether you've got Washington, or if Anderson's healthy enough to come in, you run one of those guys to the corner. Now they have third and goal.
And they'll go out of the shotgun.
And they can hardly afford to settle for a field goal, trailing by 15. And they're going to have to, or go on fourth down, because there was nothing there for Thomas Washington, and you can sense the reaction of the Bengal fans at the lack of imagination in the play calling.
Romy Wheeler comes in with the play.
It'll be fourth and goal.
See if they go to the air here. They had moved the ball at will down the field on this drive.
And now they've moved it backwards since getting first and goal at the one. It's now fourth and goal, and the ball nudging back to the two. Boy, the Broncos could really burst their bubble here. Weta to throw. Touchdown, Bengals. Wide open in the end zone. A guy not even on the three deep. Looked like 86.
Or 96. Well, if he turns around, we'll be able to see his last name. He is not on the roster. So the Bengals trailing by 9 will try to get it back down to 7.
Okay, well, here's the confusion. Travis Olson out of Hazleton and Valley High normally wears 98. At least that's the way he was listed for us. He's in 96.
All right.
And he makes the touchdown catch. And now penalty flag in the backfield. And I'm not sure what the... Since there's no huddle, they had too many men on the field, I guess. They were at the line of scrimmage illegally.
The second time they've had a penalty on a two-point conversion try. So the Broncos have now given up over 20 points for the first time since the Nevada game. Gave up 7 to Liberty, 16 to NAU, and 17 to Weber State.
5-yard penalty marches the ball back to the 8-yard line, and the Bengals will go again for 2, trailing by 9. Trying to get within a touchdown of the 16-point favorite, Broncos. Weta rolling. Once Wheeler throws. Incomplete. Another 2-point try failed. Fans wanted a penalty. There is no illegal contact judged. And with 3:10 left in the third, the Broncos up 9 they return to offense.
Willard Scott here at the Mohawk Brand Excellence Showroom. Let me show you something really neat. One of these is an ordinary carpet. The other is a DuPont Stainmaster with a revolutionary backing system called Spill Block. Now watch this. Voila! The Stainmaster carpet with Spill Block helps keep spills from soaking through. This means cleanup is a lot easier, and it helps reduce odors. Stainmaster carpet with Spill Block is available at Mohawk Brand Excellence Showrooms.
Available now at Carpet Masters in Nampa and Boise.
I want a pizza, Daddy.
If you're going to spend extra time on something,
Daddy,
spend it with your best friend, not a loan application. Call 1-800-US-LOANS.
Willie Bowen standing at his 10-yard line. Expecting a line drive kick, and he gets it, and the ball fielded by Del Graven. Across the 30 to the 35-yard line, and the first carry of the season for last year's All-Big Sky tight end. Quit the Broncos just after Doubleday started, and he said he really wanted to concentrate on school, gave up his scholarship, and now has decided after 2 months of agony that he has missed football too much, has walked on without a scholarship now, still obviously attending classes, and now without a scholarship is back as a member, a productive member now of the Bronco football team. Casey Adams, no gain at the 35.
Brian Getz right there. A missed block allows Getz to stop Casey for no gain. One more note on Del Graven. It's not like he decided that the team was 6-0 and, oh, well, I want to be a part of that. There were players that talked him into asking to come back, who wanted him back on the team.
Well,
he had to
sure,
be talked into it.
He wasn't sure what the reaction would
right.
be. At first, I understand it was a little mixed, but once they knew his motives and they also realized what a great contributor he could be to their effort to win the Big Sky and national championship. Second and 10 now, Hildy. Wants to go deep, goes short instead, has Casey Adams at the 40, and it'll be third and 5.
Hildy tried to freeze the linebackers with the punt deep. The aforementioned Dave Castro in the game right now for the Broncos. He tried to freeze the linebackers with the pump fake, but Bengals staying at home, and this is a big play in this ballgame.
Third and 5 from the Bronco 40. Leading by 9, final 2 minutes of the third quarter. Hildy wants to run, caught from behind, no gain. Broncos will have to punt. What is known as a coverage sack.
Absolutely. And one of the reasons you call that a coverage sack, the Bengals were rushing only 3. 6 defensive backs in the game. They were covering everyone, and the 3-man rush got to Tony Hildy.
Danny Weeks on for only his second punt of the night, averaging less than 39. Got off a 44-yarder in the first half. Alfredo Anderson, no. That's Spence driven back and finally brought down at the 14-yard line.
Tim Foley and Bubba Egbert, and auspicious record you mentioned by Danny Weeks. It's a durability record, though, for Danny Weeks, who had a bad back coming out of Capitol High and has hung in there, gotten better every year, and he has now punted more times than any player in Bronco history, the old record by Tom Shimmer.
And he's punted awfully well. These coaches are very concerned about replacing him next year. That's a 4-year starter who has meant a lot to this football team. Kicking very well tonight. Another one over 40. Weta on first down. A lot of time. Going deep for Wheeler. makes the catch, can't hang on.
Great job by Rasheed Gale to time his hit on Wheeler.
And Wheeler gives Rasheed Gale a shove as they separate.
Keith Watt Green getting up slowly. Good time here for Weta. He airs it out. It's a little wobbly, but on the fly, there you see Wheeler and Gale is able to knock the ball loose and create a second and 10 situation. Chris Wing comes in the long yardage situation.
From the Bengal 14-yard line.
Broncos in the nickel. DeJuan Miller and Jason Payne. Chris Cook, Keith Watt Green, and Rasheed Gale.
The handoff. Penalty flag thrown at the line of scrimmage. Kennedy and Kayeson fighting to get back to that 14-yard line.
Joe O'Brien and Travis Thompson on the stop.
We'll wait to see what the infraction is.
It's in the old holding zone. We'll see if that's the case. Broncos would have, it would be a half the distance penalty, so the Broncos may elect to decline this. It'll be third and 11 or second and about 16 or 17.
Well, Weta has made so many big throws, you might be fearful of giving him two downs.
But they're going to give him two downs. So it'll take it from the 14 down to the 7.
And the other thing that does, it really squeezes the field on the punter if you can hold them back.
They
holding
do end up
on the offense, decline.
Yeah, they'll third take down their chances on third and 11. Third and 10, actually, from the 14. So Weta's got one down to get it done.
Well, he got it done the last drive.
Clock moving in the final 40 seconds of this third quarter. Weta rolling to the near side. Joe O'Brien puts a big rush on him, and he causes Weta to underthrow his receiver, and the Bengals will have to kick it away. Chad Kay couldn't come up with that ball.
Nowhere to go anyway for Chad Kay.
And now the Broncos will have excellent, should have excellent field position. Casey Adams, in fact, is standing in Bengal territory, anticipating James Farrell's punt.
Last time Casey Adams returned one, 19 yards.
Casey averaging 12 on the season coming into this game, and of course had a 79-yarder.
The electrifying one against Cal State Northridge.
Farrell's kick is a wobbler to the near side of the field. They don't want Casey Adams to have anything to do with it, but they sacrifice a lot of field position in the process. The Broncos will have it at the Bengal 46-yard line.
22 seconds remaining in the third period. Bengals took the ball down and scored on their first possession of the second half. The Broncos answered with an 80-yard drive of their own.
So after the big punt by Danny Weeks pins the Bengals back inside their 15, the defense makes a nice stand. And now the Bronco offense has excellent field position as we wind down the final seconds of the third quarter. Leading by 9, Boise State trying to add to that advantage. Casey Adams on a quick hitter, but not quick enough. It appears that the play clock, which ran for one of the few times this evening, may have expired before they got the ball off.
Saw an official signal to his watch earlier. Now a false start. They may be keeping the time on the field.
Well, certainly they're not keeping it on the scoreboard.
Dave Castro is still in, or was in on that last play. Now he's replaced by Bernie Zimmerman, but you've got to wonder about Ryan Akibi's ribs. Hope that Ryan Akibi is okay.
Schrack at the top of the screen, Housky at the bottom. First and 15. Broncos with the ball back in their territory now. Casey Adams breaks the tackle. See into the secondary, 40, 35, 30, fumbles the ball and grabbed it back on the roll.
Is he amazing?
Did you catch that? On the roll, grabbed the ball.
When they need a big run from Casey, they get it. When they don't need a fumble, they get it. When they need a heads-up play from Casey, they get it. Here is Juke City
Get out of my way, big man.
Yeah, Kaufman out of the way, but he gets stripped by Ike Johnson from behind, reaches up, tucks it away, play over, first down Broncos on the 26.
And Ike Johnson's got to be sick that he did not hang on to Casey Adams' arms. End of the third. Casey Adams now with a 200-yard all-purpose yardage game. The Broncos in scoring territory again when we come back to start the final period.
The arteries that nourish Idaho carry water. With fresh, clean water, we've got futures. Without water, our state begins to die. Phil Batt grew up on the land. He stood at the head gate waiting for his water. He says not one drop of our water for other states. His opponent for governor favors drawdowns, which require sending Idaho water downstream. Two candidates, two distinct points of view. Phil Batt, governor.
This label tells you it's 100% cotton. This label tells you it's 100% real cheese. And this label tells you it's 100% low fares. Always check the label. Southwest, the low fare airline. On most airlines, you can only get a low fare to a few places. But Southwest has low fares everywhere we fly. So for low fares every time you fly, don't get stuck on some other airline. Southwest, the low fare airline.
If you tuned in expecting Sisters, which airs Saturday nights at 9 here on Channel 7, it will be shown in its entirety following Bronco Spotlight with Pokey Allen tomorrow night at 11:30. We appreciate the patience of the Sisters fans and hope you're enjoying the football game tonight. It has been entertaining, if at times frustrating for BSU fans. Tony Hilde, ball deflected and knocked down incomplete by Josh Hayes out of Homedale High. Recovered a fumble earlier in the game after helping to force it.
And that was his second fumble recovery of the year. He came in with 8 sacks. And he did a great job against the play fake and the roll right, the U-bump flat, as the Broncos call it. It's a play they ran a zillion times last year, and every team the Broncos faced practice against that play. Josh Hayes did a good job against it.
In motion, Bernie Zimmerman. Hilde hands to Casey Adams. Boy, does he dodge tacklers to the 20, 16, and very close to the first down. If he gets a right foot spot, he's got it.
He had no business getting more than 2 yards on that play. There was nothing there.
Look at this at the line of scrimmage. Get out of my way. Get out of my way.
Goes outside the block of Bernie Zimmerman. Gets past Ike Johnson, past Josh Brown.
And it's a first down. What a terrific runner he is.
Casey Adams, unofficially his sixth 100-yard game in 7 this season.
He leads the Big Sky in rushing. First and 10 Broncos from the 16. Adams cuts up after dodging a tackler at the line of scrimmage, fumbles, and gets it back again. A penalty flag at the line of scrimmage. No, at the 11-yard line.
That's probably bad news for Boise State.
Well, it could be a face mask. It could be a hold against the offense.
It's holding, according to Tony Hilde. And the Broncos just have not done enough things right to end this ball game.
Boy, Casey Adams is it's like spinning the revolver cylinder.
And the ball comes out. And Casey.
He worked to get that one back.
Oh.
So from the spot, the ball back to the 22-yard line.
It'll still be first down. About 17 to go.
Broncos need to get just inside the 6. Schrack and Hauske wide to the near side. Double setbacks, Johnson and Adams. Hilde gets some protection. Now he loses the ball, and the Bengals, I think, might have gotten it. No. First man had a shot, 95, Tom Prudhomme out of Highland High in Pocatello. Couldn't come up with it.
John Miller got it. Boy, I thought he had it. I thought Prudhomme had it. 3 fumbles on this drive by Boise State.
Prudhomme was extremely frustrated because it hit him in the chest, I think. I mean, it came right in his face.
Alapate Taualupe in there, and it is Josh Hayes out of Homedale who forces the fumble. It sure looked like Prudhomme had it, but the ball's still loose. It wasn't Miller.
It was someone else diving in at the last second.
Might
so here
KC.
We are, second and 22. Hilde now has time, now going deep and just overthrown. Bernie Zimmerman couldn't make the catch at the goal line. And he's upset with himself.
He might be shaken up a little bit. Neither player looks like he feels particularly well. Free safety Josh Brown, who was covering on that play, limping a little bit as well. Broncos have scripted plays for every situation. They have a whole long list of them for third and long and second and long. And Al Board just going through the sheet right now. Looks like Zimmerman's okay. So the Broncos are just on the edge of Greg Erickson's field goal range right now. 9-point lead with 13:20 left in the game.
Scoreboard showing fourth down, but the yardage markers on the sideline correctly indicate third and 22. Actually, about third and 20 and a half. They've got to get just inside the six. And the ball is creeping right up on the 26-yard line.
The fans think it is fourth down. They can't believe Boise State's going for it.
Hilde. It's time. Here comes Hayes. Hilde got his man. Housky first. No. Just a yard short.
But now the fans aren't going to believe that the Broncos have another play. Will they bring Greg Erickson in? Good time here for Tony Hilde.
Looks like the Broncos are going to go on fourth and...
Wow.
Fourth and a long one, almost 2 yards. And maybe a long count, try to draw him offside and then take the field goal.
Could be. Nine on the play clock.
Little gamble. Casey Adams, he won't get there.
I don't understand why you don't get the 3 points.
Big emotional lift. Well, you're up by nine, and the three puts you up by 12. It does give you a touchdown and field goal lead.
Exactly.
Which you still have now.
Well, you have a two-touchdown lead here if you're up by 12. I mean, they have to score two touchdowns to get you if you're up by 12.
So the Broncos gamble and fail. A big emotional lift for ISU and their fans. We'll see what the Bengals can do with it as they start from their 7-yard line.
Matt Weston in for Fafita.
Weta from his end zone. Pass caught on the far side.
Kennedy Nikiason.
Out across the 10 to the 13-yard line. A gain of 6. Second and 4.
Tione Fafita, I saw him on the bench earlier. He is now standing on the sideline next to defensive coordinator Tom Mason, but Weston in for him right now.
Nikiason out across the 20. Bengal first down.
Well, they may have found a new Alfredo in Kennedy Nikiason. Seldom used until tonight. He didn't want to try it with Thomas Washington backing up the apparently injured Alfredo Anderson, so they've been going with the 13 guy.
Anderson standing at the near sideline with a baseball cap on, so he's apparently done for the night.
Pads off.
First down Bengals from the 21. Weta wants to go deep, got a man across the 40. Ruled down by contact. That's Justin Young, the youngster out of Hawaii, a redshirt freshman, 160-pounder.
He was seldom used up until tonight as well. A great play fake that time by Rob Weta. The Broncos are starting to pay attention to Kennedy Nikiason.
22-yard gain. Bengals now at the 44. Lots of time, 11 and a half minutes remaining. Word from the BSU Pavilion that Idaho State and Boise State have split their first 4 games in women's volleyball. Kennedy and Kiason into the Bronco territory and diving for a first down to the BSU 37-yard line.
And Chris Shepard complaining to the official about a hold by number 76, Steve Birch, on the right side here. Look at Shepard's jersey. Look at Shepard's jersey. He's got a case.
He can't get turned around, but there's no call, and it's a first down Bengals at the Bronco 37.
Sione Fifita now returns to the game for the Broncos. Matt Weston comes out.
Clock continues to run, approaching the 11-minute mark. A lot of football left here. Very entertaining college football game.
Backup fullback Craig Joseph on the dive.
Joseph, a true freshman. Half a dozen true freshmen playing on this team. Brian McNeely in his third season as Bengal head coach in very much the same position Pokey Allen found himself last year, needing that infusion of young talent.
Hildy Akibi, John Miller, Jeremy Hainer, Sione Fifita, Ed Rayford, all playing as true freshmen last year for Boise State.
Loss of half yards, second and call it 11. Weta now runs away from Fifita, chased by O'Brien, and run out of bounds before Dewan Miller can get at him at the 34-yard line.
And gains about 3.5 yards out of it.
So it'll be third and 7. A huge down for the Bengals.
Wholesale changes now. On third and long, Chris Wing comes in. He plays on the left side, Joe O'Brien on the right side as the defensive ends for Boise State.
Bengals will go with four wide receivers on third and 7.
Stephon Reed's got to cover one of them.
Weta gets a rush and overthrows his intended receiver, and that's Sam Carter at the 30-yard line. Wasn't going to have first down yardage, but now they're faced with fourth.
And they are out of field goal range.
Yeah, this would be a 51-yard field goal. Timeout. Brian McNeely wants timeout with 10:16 left. He's got a big decision to make. And we'll fill you in on what he decides when we come back.
It's Blacker's 45th anniversary sale, and you'll find huge savings on the area's largest selection of America's name brand furniture, appliances, carpeting, and electronics. Camcorders just $398, color TVs $158, Lazy Boys at $198, plus get two free airline tickets to Orlando, the Bahamas, Cancun, Mexico, or Hawaii with any purchase of $599 or more. 6 months same as cash, savings up to 70% during the 45th anniversary sale on now at Blacker's, where you always buy for less.
Every morning at each and every taco time, we're starting fresh. Yeah, it's a lot of work. It takes time. We could do it the easy way, but we know you'd taste the difference. You want your food made fresh, naturally. Food this good doesn't happen overnight. It happens every morning. Now enjoy crisp meat or bean burritos, just 99 cents. Crisp chicken burritos, just $1.69.
We make it fresh every day. Taco time.
Still better than 10 minutes to play. We've seen several big plays, emotional lifts for each team so far this evening, and we're about to see another. The Bengals appear ready to go for it on fourth and 7 from the Bronco 39. The crowd rising to cheer. Now that can be a negative if they get too loud, because the Bengals will want to be adjusting the play at the line of scrimmage. So
Broncos,
they settle right back down. A lot of offense tonight, and the Bengals trying to convert here and keep this drive alive. Fourth and 7. Weta handing. No. Whistle before the snap.
I don't think the play clock could have possibly counted down.
Perhaps procedure.
That's what it looks like.
Dead ball. Ball start.
Oh, now
on
they
the
got
offense.
To get 12 and
5
seven,
yards.
7.
Now you almost back yourself into punt territory now. Weta stays out, and McNeely's not changing his mind. Kennedy and Kayson thought he was coming out, but now he's returning. And Thomas Washington will leave.
They had some kind of a reverse setup, or a fake reverse. Nikiasen may have been on the fake reverse and then going out in the pass pattern.
Fourth and 12. Weta to throw. Got his man, Romy Wheeler. First down, Bengals at the 21-yard line. Great throw. Got him between defenders.
With the exception of Chris Cook's interception and the fumble recovery in the first quarter, the Broncos have not been able to make the big play on defense tonight. Plenty of time for Rob Weta.
Just got that ball over Brian Smith's
outstretched
arm. So the Bengals with a fresh set of downs. First and 10 from the Bronco 21. Each team had turned in a fourth down stop earlier in the game. And Kiason to the 19.
Joe O'Brien on the stop. Stephon Reed making a last minute switch to the left side of the defensive line, and he was coming.
A reminder that Sisters, normally shown during this hour, will be seen tomorrow night following the Pokey Allen show. 11:30 tomorrow night, Sisters in its entirety. 9.5 minutes remaining here in Pocatello. The play fake to Nkiasen, and Weta has to dump it off, intending it for Romy Wheeler.
Pressure from Chris Wing.
And it'll be third and 8.
Tried to set up the screen on the right side, but the pressure forced Weta to hurry the throw and underthrow the thing. So here's another big play in this ball game, although once again, I think the Bengals, well, no, they may not be in two-down territory here. They are in field goal range. They need a field goal and a touchdown to take the lead.
Yeah, I think if you don't make it here, you take the 3 points and consider yourself fortunate.
Boy, the Bengals have had some big third down plays tonight and fourth down, and now they burn their second timeout.
ISU using one of its two remaining timeouts. They'll have one left and 9:23 to play with a big third and 7 when we come back.
Financial independence and security don't just happen. You've got to make them happen. And given the opportunity, we'll show you how they can happen. Higgins and Rutledge, the insurance agency. It's easy for any agency to advertise its list of services. We'd rather explain them to you personally. After all, your insurance is a very personal thing to you and to us. Higgins and Rutledge, the insurance agency.
Dakota Sport V6 has more. More horsepower. More shoulder room. More hip room. And more cargo room than a comparable Ford Ranger or Chevy S10. But you don't have to put everything you've got into it. Dakota Sport V6. A little bigger, a lot better.
See all that's new at your friendly Northwest Dodge dealer.
9:23 remaining. Broncos up by 9 on the Bengals. Idaho State with a 3rd and 7 from the Boise State 19-yard line. Rob Weta on the evening, 24 of 37. 3 touchdowns, 1 interception, 272 yards in passing offense. He's had a terrific evening, and trying to add to those numbers here in, to this point, the biggest play of the night for the Bengals. Gets a rush, gets his man, and no gain, maybe even a loss.
A loss of 2 on the play as Stephon Reed makes the hit on Thomas Washington.
Down at the 20. And now the kick team comes out, and James Farrell will attempt a field goal.
Here's some pressure for a true freshman from Bishop, California.
This will be 37 yards out of Kirk Clifford's hold to bring the Bengals within 6. He nailed it. 8:45 remaining, and the Broncos' once imposing 15-point lead has been cut to less than a touchdown.
Broncos right now hoping the defense can do, or rather the offense can do enough to win this ball game. 412 yards total offense so far for Boise State, but only a 6-point lead. Tony Hilde has had a pretty good night. 15 of 21, 261 yards and 2 touchdowns, but one interception. All night long on the kickoff, ISU has been squibbing to keep the ball away from.
And now the kick team comes out, and James Farrell will attempt a field goal.
Here's some pressure for a true freshman from Bishop, California.
This will be 37 yards out of Kirk Clifford's hold to bring the Bengals within six. He nailed it. 8:45 remaining, and the Broncos' once imposing 15-point lead has been cut to less than a touchdown.
Broncos right now hoping the defense can do, or rather the offense can do enough to win this ball game. 412 yards total offense so far for Boise State, but only a 6-point lead. Tony Hilde has had a pretty good night. 15 of 21, 261 yards and two touchdowns, but one interception. All night long on the kickoff, ISU has been squibbing to keep the ball away from Willie Bowen.
Well, the Broncos have had their chances to put this one away, and as they have seen happen the last couple of weeks, they have let an underdog hang around long enough now that the game is in jeopardy in the fourth quarter. A lot of time left and a big possession upcoming for the Boise State offense. Del Graven, who returned kickoffs regularly for the Broncos last year, is back there along with Willie Bowen.
Broncos not expecting the onside this early. 8:45 left in the game.
And the eye of the Tiger resounds through the Minidome again.
He picks it away.
They're going to give Bowens a chance this time from the 3-yard line, straight upfield. He's got blockers. Across the 20 to the 26-yard line.
Now a very important possession for Boise State. Leading by only six. Another long drive by ISU, 73 yards on that one. Almost 4 minutes of possession, and Farrell getting a pressure field goal from 37 yards out.
Broncos' unbeaten season hangs in the balance now in the final 8:40. Casey Adams stopped after a no gain. Report from the pavilion, Idaho State has won game five and taken its volleyball match from Boise State 3-2. So the struggle continues for Darlene Bailey and her BSU women's volleyball team.
Corey Johnson has gone all the way at fullback. He comes out now.
Dave Castro in motion. Tony Hilde coming back to Casey Adams, waiting for a couple of blockers, and gets some help and takes it out to the 35. Paul Kaufman looked like he might be shaken up, but he bounces up. It'll be third and one.
Kaufman expected a better block out of himself. Tony looks right as he has two receivers streaking and then throws the screen back to KC. KC waiting for the blocking to set up, and it never really happened. Content to get nine on it.
Big down for the Broncos.
Oh,
and the Bengal defense. This crowd will be loud. Third and one. Adams, first down and more across the 40. And then pushed back.
Bengals might start going for the ball now since Casey fumbled twice on the last drive. He's awfully good at getting that thing back, though. You see Casey walk gingerly back to the huddle. He has been hurt since two-a-days in August.
Yeah, but it's kind of the old Jim Brown limp I'm beginning to feel.
Well,
you feel like he just doesn't quite have enough left to finish, and boom, he's gone.
Well, I think he hurts. I really believe it.
He sure doesn't show it when he gets that football in his hands.
No.
First down Broncos at their 40. Hilde with the play fake. Running room, penalty flag in the Bronco backfield as Hilde has lots of yardage. Caught from behind at the 28, but it'll probably come back.
Housky is down.
He fell hard. Phil Lucky, the ISU trainer, quickly out. No, it's the team doctor. Quickly out to minister to him. He's shaken up. And they can ill afford to have him sit down with Ryan Akibi already out.
It is a hold against Boise State, so it'll be first. And if it's from the point of infraction, first and 25. Flag thrown 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Housky gingerly walking off the field, using the word gingerly a lot tonight. We have not seen Ryan Akibi since first possession of the second half.
See if we can pick up the hold.
Well,
we
might call it on KC.
Yeah, it's probably right there. Maybe on Keith Jeffrey as well. He had a hold of the back of a jersey.
6:41 left in the game. The Broncos holding on.
That's a huge penalty. It looked like Housky got fallen on by the two guys diving forward. Broncos have got to cross the 50 for a first down. So it is first and a little more than 25.
Broncos have two tight ends in the game now. The only wide receiver left is Lee Schrack.
Zimmerman, the motion man. Schrack threw his hands incomplete. Second and 25.
And Schrack goes down hard after being hung out to dry a little bit.
.625 remaining.
Jared Housky back into the game now for the Broncos.
This is a huge possession for both teams. The Broncos, if they can get a couple of first downs, can burn most of the clock because Idaho State's only got one timeout. It gets tight, they'll be unable to stop the clock, but the Broncos have got to get a first down to accomplish that.
Therefore, they have to pass and completion stop the clock.
Casey Adams gets a block, but just gets to the 33-yard line. And it'll be third and 17.
Trap that the Broncos have had so much success with, inside trap. Casey, as we mentioned, over 100 yards, but he would trade that for a victory right now.
Alex Toyos being helped off the far side, and that's a huge loss. And I'm not speaking only of his 288 pounds. He is considered the most consistent and best performing offensive lineman the Broncos have this season.
And a quiet leader on that front. So Steve Brushy, number 77, in at right guard.
Third and 17. Castro in motion. And a flag before the snap.
Nobody heard it. Except Tony Hilde. Third and 22 it will be.
Dead ball. Ball start.
So perhaps the crowd noise causing problems as Tony Hilde tries to relay the play information at the line of scrimmage. It's all part of being a road team. You got to fight your way through it.
Broncos have been penalized a lot tonight.
Bengals exhorting the crowd to make it even tougher. They are 4 of 9, are the Broncos. That's a good number, but they really need number 5. Hilde looking for room. Had a man open. Incomplete. Hilde couldn't get the ball into the secondary. And he's shaken up. Perhaps just frustrated as much as anything. Official timeout, 5:26 remaining, and Ike Johnson shaken up for ISU, just being helped to his feet.
The Broncos getting the pressure, or the Bengals getting the pressure on the quarterback that the Broncos want to get. You see Tony Hilde being led to the bench.
So he is not in the best of shape.
Andy Burrell would come into the game should Tony be unable to return. You've got to bet on Tony Hilde coming back, though.
Danny Weeks, to kick it away. David Spence waiting at the Idaho State 35. A big moment for Weeks. Needs a big punt. Doesn't get it. A wobbler that hits at the 45 and then takes a Bronco bounce inside the 30, out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Well, everything working for Danny Weeks. He got a huge break there. We'll take one now. 5:16 to play. Bronco is trying to protect a 6-point lead.
No matter how many little surprises life throws your way, there's one thing you can count on. The energy-efficient warmth of a Tempstar furnace. Find out how you can rely on Tempstar.
Call Empire Heating, 322-6007 for a no-obligation free estimate on a reliable Tempstar gas furnace. Install a Tempstar furnace for comfort and reliability. Natural gas when cost and comfort are important to you.
What if you took the best-selling car in America, Ford Taurus, and gave it something special, like sport bucket seats, a rear spoiler, and aluminum wheels, and then you added a whole list of other standard features like dual airbags, air conditioning, and power windows and locks? Well, you'd probably have a car that just went out of your price range, right? Wrong. Introducing the new 95 Taurus SE, a special edition. Now with the same 2.9% financing or 500 cash back you can get on every Taurus model. For limited time, only at your local Ford dealer.
Idaho State with possession. Bengals at their own 27-yard after about a 20-yard roll for Danny Weeks on that punt. And that has helped a little bit ease the problem facing Boise State's defense. But they have been on their heels in this second half, leading now by 6 with 5 minutes and 16 seconds to play. Rob Weta to throw. Penalty flag thrown at the cup, protecting Weta, and that generally means offensive holding.
That would be a big break for Boise State if that were the case, because it would be marked from the point of infraction,
which is the 20, which would put the ball at the 10.
Yeah, it was the 19, so it's half the distance. They have to get to the 37 for first down.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. So they'll be back inside the 10-yard line, still with first down. And they have had a propensity tonight to convert those big third down plays. Rob Weta has played, I would say, the game of his season.
Hokie Allen didn't show a lot of concern at halftime, but he's got a lot of concern now. And behind him, you can see Ryan Akibi with his right knee.
On the offense, repeat first down.
His right knee wrapped. There he is.
On crutches.
Right knee wrapped on crutches and his
Well, that's about the worst scene you could imagine if you're a Bronco fan. That may mean long-term problems. And there's a guy you desperately need down the stretch. First down. Weta, under pressure, does get it away and manages to flip it over Jason Payne's head. And it falls harmlessly incomplete.
Good job by Weta to throw the ball away. Boy, it's dangerous when you throw it in the field of play and throw it away, especially when you throw it up in the air instead of at somebody's feet.
Of course, he had to be careful that he didn't throw it too far away from his intended receiver, because he does not need an intentional grounding. As you can see, the numerous penalties assessed against both teams tonight.
The Bronco second penalties have been very hurtful.
Second down and 27. Bengals inside their 10-yard line, trailing by 6 with 5:05 to play. Weta rolling away again, now throwing back. Open field.
Kennedy Nikiason once again.
Gain of 10, and it'll be third and 17. Clock now continues to run with less than 5 minutes.
Boy, the Broncos really need to get out of this drive. They have a third and long. And you'll see a great block thrown here by, I believe, Steve Mutsayers, the left tackle on Brian Smith.
Yeah,
Brian Smith comes back to make the tackle.
But he bought another 5 yards for Nikiason. Third and make it 16 from the 21. Going deep. Rashid Gale can't make the catch. The Bengals will have to punt.
Kirk Clifford tried to play defense on that as the ball was overthrown.
Here's a good look at the Centennial High School graduate.
The winner of the Harrison's Jewelers ISU Bengal Lodge.
As we mentioned, a 1,000-yard rusher for the Patriots in 89 is converted to a wide receiver. And he's still only a sophomore because of a two-year LDS mission.
Well, a great stand by the Bronco defense, helped by the holding call on first down. And now, a chance to put this game away. James Farrell standing inside his 10. Casey Adams awaiting the punt near midfield. Adams signaling fair catch at the 44-yard line. And that's where the Broncos will have it with 4:12 remaining. The Bengals can only stop the clock once. They have just one timeout. So if the Broncos keep it on the ground and pick up a first down or two, this game is over. If they make a mistake, they could be in deep water.
They need a good run on first down here. I can't imagine them passing on first down. I think you can expect Casey Adams to get the ball here, and they need a good run on first down.
The unexpected, though.
Zimmerman will go in motion.
Casey Adams picks up about three.
Not quite what the Broncos wanted, but they'll burn some clock with that. Approaching the four-minute mark right now.
4 minutes exactly. And they'll take all the 25-second play clock, which starts just now.
Well, it started a second late, and that's to the Broncos' benefit. ISU has given BSU everything it could want tonight.
Tony Hilde taking his time. He's still got 10 on the play clock and wanting to use as much of it as he can. 3:30 to play. Casey Adams caught behind the line of scrimmage, and the Broncos are in a real defensive mode right now.
They have taken the air out of the ball, not wanting to risk an interception, and now they may have to go to the air to try to get that first down or put it on the defense to stop Idaho State.
3:10 as the play clock starts. So subtract 25, and it'll be about 2:50 when this play starts. Third and 12. Hilde to throw. Got his man. Great catch, Jared Housky. First down, Broncos.
Oh, Housky's been doing that since he was a freshman, but boy, is he having a year.
What a catch. And that just about does it.
The defender fell down. Hilde gets this off just before Josh Hayes reaches him. You see the defender down. If Housky had been able to catch that on the fly, if. But as it is, the Broncos have 2:43 on the clock. They have a first down. ISU has one timeout remaining.
Well, that's the catch of the year in keeping this unbeaten season alive. 2:34. Casey Adams caught behind the line. And the Bengals are going to have to think about spending their timeout at some point, because the Broncos are running 20 to 30 seconds for every play. We're down to the 2:15 mark now.
Hope that Casey Adams doesn't go back under 100 yards.
Tom's headed for the field to get reaction from Pokey Allen when this one's over. And it'll be about 1:50 on the clock when this play starts. Second and 13. Adams not quite back to the line of scrimmage. The Broncos obviously taking their time getting up, very content to use as much time as possible. 1:30 remaining. It'll be about 1:10 on the clock when the next play begins. Third and 11. First down here, ball game over. Come up short, could have trouble. Hilde running from pressure, caught, penalty flag, and another. Now it'll be a question of who the penalty's against. And if it's against the Broncos, Idaho State will surely decline and force the punt and get the ball. Holding against Boise State. Let's give you another look. Top of your screen, holding. Maybe Jordy LePain, 74.
That's declined. It's fourth down.
And he just kind of rides his guy down. The problem he had is he had the arm hooked. So it's fourth down. The clock stopped with the penalty. Broncos have called a timeout. We'll take one as well. Idaho State's called the timeout. 1:03 remaining. Broncos will punt it when we come back.
Each day when he leaves home for work, he takes with him one value above all others, a commitment to be true to his beliefs and honest about them. Now in this election, he's asked his opponent to sign a clean campaign pledge to focus on issues, not negative attacks. Perhaps the Idaho Falls paper said it best. In a time of screaming politics and conflict, Echo Hawk is so dignified, so obviously fair and reasonable, the word politician seems scarcely to apply. Strength, character, and purpose. Echo Hawk for Idaho.
Blind date at Chili's. How about some buffalo wings? Says appetizer. Lets her know a guy like me won't wait around forever.
Maybe I'll get the chicken Caesar salad.
That way I'll be light on my feet if we go dancing later.
I see they have grilled chicken pasta with vegetables.
Sophisticated. Says to her I don't wear a clip-on tie. Tells her I can work a corkscrew.
I like this guy. He really has his act together.
Uh-oh. I think I locked my keys in the car.
Larry Manili back with you from the press box. Tom Scott on the sideline. Danny Weeks standing at his 40, ready to kick it to David Spence, who is at the Idaho State 10-yard line. And Weeks needs a big one here. A big rush. He gets a boomer that Spence fields and fumbles! And Idaho State might have it. No, the Broncos, I think, have got the ball. We'll wait for them to unpile, but there's a look of frustration. No, it is recovered by Idaho State at the bottom of the pile. Boy, David Spence made a huge mistake there. Tom, he was pinned against the sideline. I can't imagine why he tried to catch that ball.
It's a mystery to me. I couldn't see it from this angle, blocked by the ISU bench, but I saw him make a play on the ball. Go ahead and describe it, Larry.
I mean, he's at the 6-yard line and doesn't even get close to fielding it cleanly, but the Bengals somehow come up with the football. There was initially a reaction of celebration from a couple of Broncos, some frustration from Idaho State. The net result, the Bengals have got the ball. And going deep for Romy Wheeler! Got the ball! 35, caught from behind at the 22-yard line. 44 seconds left.
Oh, is this just like 2 years ago?
Yogi would say deja vu all over again.
Plenty of time.
What a great throw by Rob Weta. And Romy Wheeler just ran by three defenders. And DeJuan Miller saves the day so far. Clock moving. Bengals with no timeouts. 40 seconds left. Weta. It's a big rush. Has to throw it away. And that's exactly what he did. But no grounding call despite the pleading of secondary coach Ron Gould on the far sideline. Pass, nobody close.
Pass looked like it was intended for Ron Gould over there. The pressure coming from Chris Wing, and to avoid the sack and to stop the clock, Weta had to let it go.
Another great look at the long completion to Romy Wheeler. 32 seconds left, second and 10 at the 22. No timeouts left for Idaho State. If they go down the middle, they've got to get to the end zone or risk big trouble. Knocked away by DeJuan Miller.
Boy, and that would have looked like the play 2 years ago that Romy Wheeler scored on. Sam Carter, open momentarily, a quick close by DeJuan Miller.
What a great effort by DeJuan Miller coming from nowhere to save the game.
DeJuan's had a couple of those this year.
That's a terrific effort by Dewan Miller. Third and 10, 27 seconds left. Weta rolling from pressure, throws to the end zone. Touchdown!
There it is.
Now, need I remind you, the Bengals missed their first conversion kick of the night, and the Big Sky has overtime, so here's a huge point. It's good. Give you another look at the touchdown. Chris Cook had Kirk Clifford covered, but he got, or Dewan Miller got caught going the wrong way. Twenty seconds left. The Broncos just about out of magic. They have made enough mistakes tonight to seriously jeopardize their undefeated season now.
They could not make a big play on defense. 94 yards on that drive.
10,000 plus cheering as one. Willie Bowens will try to give the Broncos good field position if, in fact, he's allowed to even touch the ball. Broncos do have three timeouts, so they'll be able to use the whole field offensively. But they'll only have time for three, maybe four plays at the most. And they'll have to go 80 yards to get it done.
This would be the magic of magic.
Well, Pokey Allen talks about these kids having some kind of magic. They've been driving him crazy with the mistakes they make. They will need some big magic to get out of this hole.
80 yards and 20 seconds. Michael Richmond, the burner in the game for the Broncos.
Housky, Schrack, and Castro to the near side, and Richmond at the top of your screen. The four wide guys.
Three-man rush for ISU.
And two deep safeties standing at the 50. Oh, Hildy had Richmond, but he couldn't hang on. Second and 10. Trying to get Richmond in the secondary with his speed, one-on-one with somebody that he can run by. 16 seconds remaining. A reminder, the new Center 7 weekend night report upcoming as soon as we're done.
They're going to have to go with Big Ben, and they're setting it up right now with Schrack, Housky, and Castro.
Hildy, caught from behind, has to call a timeout to have any chance. And does with 8 seconds left. But Josh Hayes got him. The Homedale graduate has had a terrific evening. Some Southwest Idaho boys celebrating on the black side of the field.
And it's really Idaho State's offense and passing game has just been magnificent tonight. Rob Weta really had a night.
Let me bring you up on Weta. 27 of 45, 363 yards, and four touchdowns. There's your Big Sky Offensive Player of the Week. unless Tony Hilde can pull a rabbit out of the hat on the last play. And this may very well be it. 8 seconds left. Hilde, way overthrown, intercepted and dropped. 1 second remains. With Hildy's arm strength, they need somebody who can run faster, and they've got some burners out there.
Even with Big Ben set up, you got to have a lateral in there somewhere, or hope for a deflection. You got to hope for a fluke now.
Timeout, Boise State. Offensive coordinator Al Borges wants to talk it over, and in fact all the wide receivers come over to join Hilde.
Casey Adams should head over there too. Casey should be a part of this last play. Well, the Broncos, who were expected to play well, had their best practice of the season this week in Boise.
Well, that man's been telling you that they've been playing with fire the last 2 or 3 weeks, and he was fearful that the string would run out if they continued to make the costly mistakes that they have again made tonight. One interception, a couple of fumbles lost, and that's all it takes. You allow an underdog to hang in and grab some emotion and some momentum from this home crowd, and you got yourself problems. And the Broncos have got a big one right now. 1 second left. There's the lateral, and it's all over as Casey Adams is driven out of bounds. And the Idaho State Bengals have upset previously unbeaten Boise State. Embarrassing for them to have to admit it, but the best news for the Broncos is they don't have to play here anymore, because they have had their hands full trying to get a victory on this field. Here's another look at the game winner as Weta, the true freshman, finds Centennial High grad Kirk Clifford for the biggest catch of his career.
Defense couldn't get out of a drive when it needed to most.
We didn't play very well the whole game. We had to keep letting people back in. That's what happens. You lose a game you probably should have won. We had a zillion holding calls. We took ourselves out of the game. We didn't play very well at the last drive.
You had a great week of practice. You expected the team to play well. Is there any explanation?
I don't have any explanation, but we didn't play very well, I'll tell you that.
The task of bouncing back now, and having one conference loss and having another road game ahead of you.
Well, we'll get it back. Maybe this is good for us. We start thinking we're magic, and you're not magic all the time, and all of a sudden we blew some coverages, did some things wrong, and lost a football game. So we could have lost a lot more than this if we don't get it back.
Have you lost some players tonight due to injury?
Yeah, we got some people banged up and hurt, and it really hurt us running our offense, but I mean, I'm sure they had some players injured too. That's no excuse. You got to play with injuries.
Pokey, thanks. See you tomorrow night. Head coach Pokey Allen, very disappointed, as is the entire Boise State football team, after a 32-31 loss here in Holt Arena. Back up to you, Larry.
Okay, Tom, and we'll be back to wrap it up in just 1 minute. Want to get you into the news as quickly as we can, so stay with us.
Come on.
Yeah. I want to beat you, Daddy.
If you're going to spend extra time on something,
Daddy,
spend it with your best friend, not paying bills. Call 1-800-US-BANKS.
The arteries that nourish Idaho carry water. With fresh, clean water, we've got futures. Without water, our state begins to die. Phil Batt grew up on the land. He stood at the head gate waiting for his water. He says not one drop of our water for other states. His opponent for governor favors drawdowns, which require sending Idaho water downstream. Two candidates, two distinct points of view. Phil Batt, governor.
The new traditions that Brian McNeely has begun include singing the school fight song at the end of a big games, and this is the biggest that Brian McNeely and his Bengals have played this season or any of the previous two. They won over the Broncos 2 years ago, but this was an unbeaten Boise State team. Tom, some final thoughts?
Final thought is something we talked about in the fourth quarter. Broncos not going for the field goal that would have put them up 34 to 22. Second guess time, you know, 2020 hindsight, but that would have put the game away as it turned out.
Well, the Broncos eat their first loss of the season and must bounce back by heading for Bozeman to play the Montana State Bobcats. And they gave Idaho all they wanted today and, in fact, had a chance with 3 minutes left to go ahead in that one. Taco Time player of the game, no question about it, for his performance tonight. True freshman quarterback Rob Weta, 27 of 45, 363 yards. Yes, he was intercepted, but yes, he threw four touchdown passes, the last with 20 seconds remaining to Centennial High grad Kirk Clifford, the game winner, as the Bengals upset the Big West bound Boise State Broncos 32-31. From Holt Arena in Pocatello, for everyone involved with our telecast, good night and thanks for being with us. Stay tuned for the weekend night report here on KTVB Channel 7 in Boise.
Tonight's game between the Boise State Broncos and the Idaho State Bengals, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Flying the low-fare airline is just plain smart. U.S. Bank of Idaho. We're here for the real risk-takers in Idaho. Small business owners. Blacker's Complete Home Furnishings. America's name brand headquarters, where you always buy for less. Chili's Grill and Bar. Chili's. It's like no place else. And your Treasure Valley Dodge dealers. See all that's new from the new Dodge at your Treasure Valley Dodge dealer.
This is KTVB, Idaho's news channel. This is the News Center 7 Weekend Night Report.
Good evening and thanks for staying with us. I'm Mike Connaughton. John Dobkin has the night off. As Election Day nears, the push is on to raise money to fund those 11th hour campaigns. For Proposition 1, money is coming in from around the country in support of both sides. News Center 7's Richard Pyatt updates the campaign.